BGMC. The biblical truth lives here. Ancient Hebrew scriptures foretold of the Anointed One, Yeshua HaMashiach. The Messiah Yeshua came to call the people back to the truth of His Word and to follow that righteous path. Yeshua then called Jewish men to be His disciples, and after His death and resurrection, those Jewish men told the world about the Jewish Messiah. Now, after 2,000 years, Beth Goyim Messianic Congregation has that same calling of those Jewish men, telling all people, both Jew and Gentile, about the proper ancient path, teaching the Route 66 King's Highway from Genesis through to Revelation, and how you need and can get back to the proper roots of the faith and a closer walk with God. Now, let's hear the message.
We're going to be doing part two of Shavuot.
Vamos a mirar parte número dos de Shavuot.
The intermediate study.
El estudio intermediario.
Last week we went over mostly the Brit Hadashah.
La semana pasada repasamos casi todo el Brit Hadashah.
Now this week we're going to take it to the Old Testament.
Ahora esta semana vamos a mirar al Viejo Testamento.
To see what they were doing in the Brit Hadashah.
A ver lo que ellos estaban haciendo en el Brit Hadashah.
So going on to slide number two.
So ahora en la página número dos.
Why is Shavuot so important to Jehovah?
¿Por qué es Shavuot tan importante a Jehovah?
This day is the day He gave us His marriage contract.
Este día fue el día que él nos entregó el contrato de matrimonio.
So there's a lot of things that we need to understand about this day.
So hay muchas cosas que debemos de entender sobre este día.
That when, you know, Jehovah chooses a day to give us His word.
Cuando Jehová escoge un día para darnos su palabra.
It's a day that we should really understand.
Es un día que en verdad deberemos de entender.
Because, you know, people mark days of their own.
Porque hay personas que marcan los días propios.
You know, the day your child said their first word.
El día que tu hijo dijo su primer palabra.
The day your child rode their bicycle on their own.
El día que su hijo corrió su bicicleta solo.
And crashed on their own.
Y cayó y atropezó solo.
The day you got your driver's license.
El día que recibiste tu licencia de conducir.
Yeah, or the day you got married.
O el día que te casaste.
These are all dates that are important to each person.
Estas fechas son importantes para cada persona.
So imagine how important this day of Shavuot is to God.
So imagínate lo importante que este día de Shavuot es para Dios.
And it's a day that we all need to fully understand.
Y es un día que tenemos que completamente entender.
Because it's a day that does not have a date that we're going to see.
Porque es un día que no tiene fecha como vamos a ver.
It's a day that starts off with us looking at the heavens.
Es un día que comienza con nosotros mirando hacia los cielos.
Okay, so if you forgot your wedding anniversary.
So si te olvidaste el aniversario de tu matrimonio.
I think the ladies would get kind of angry at us men.
Yo creo que las mujeres se enojarían con nosotros los hombres.
Okay. The men aren't as much into it, but still.
Los hombres no están tan metidos en eso, pero todavía.
But if we're made in the image and likeness of God.
Pero si somos hechos en el en la imagen y semejanza de Dios.
Then we must understand how important this day should be to Him.
Entonces debemos de entender lo importante que este día es para Él.
And if we are His children,
y si somos sus hijos,
then it should be important to us.
Entonces debe de ser importante para nosotros.
Now we go on to the, turn to Exodus, Shemot chapter 19.
Vamos a Éxodo capítulo 19.
We're going to start our intermediate study.
Vamos a comenzar nuestro estudio intermediario.
I think we're going to have at least two more parts to this Holy Day.
Creo que va a haber dos partes más para este día santo.
Because in this part we're going to go over what happened in chapter 19.
Porque en esta parte vamos a repasar lo que sucedió en el capítulo 19.
Next week we're going to go over what happened in chapter 20.
La próxima semana vamos a ver lo que sucedió en el capítulo 20.
And then the week after that we're going to go over what happened in Leviticus 23.
Y después de eso vamos a mirar lo que sucedió en Levíticos capítulo 23.
So there's a lot to this particular holy day.
So hay mucho que se trata de este día santo.
That sadly most people don't pay a great attention to.
Que tristemente mucha gente no le presta atención.
But God does.
Pero Dios sí.
So Exodus 19 verses 1, 2, and 3.
Exodus capítulo 19 versículos 1 al 3.
In the third month after the people of Israel had left the land of Mitzrayim, the same day they came to the Sinai Desert. After setting out from Rephidim and arriving at the Sinai Desert, they set up camp in the desert, there in front of the mountain. Israel set up camp. Moshe went up to Elohim, and Jehovah called to him from the mountain. Here is what you are to say to the household of Yaakov, to tell the people of Israel. Okay? So the key starting point of this.
So la clave que comienza todo esto.
Is that we have in verse 1.
Tenemos en el versículo 1.
A time reference.
Una referencia de tiempo.
And when there's a time reference,
y cuando hay una referencia de tiempo,
that means we as his children should notice this date.
Eso quiere decir que nosotros como sus hijos debemos de prestar atención a esta fecha.
So when would the third month be?
So ¿cuándo sería el tercer mes?
Okay, so what do we do in the first month?
¿Qué hacemos en el primer mes?
We have what holy days in the first month?
¿Qué días santos en el primer mes?
What holy days? Can you name me one holy day in God's first month? I'm a little deaf. I went to way too many concerts. You don't know. Okay, well, it's a good thing you're here at Bible study then. What about you there, Señor Francis? Can you name me one holy day in the first month?
Sí, en la fiesta del primer mes. Uno de las fiestas.
Pesach.
Huh? Pesach. Pesach. Ruthie! Ruthie! Name me another one. It looks a little like this. Something really flat. Hag matzah. Okay. Margarita, name the third one. Very good. También, también. Okay, so we've named the three holy days of Pesach, Hag matzah, and Bikurim.
Sí, ya nombramos los primeros tres fiestas en el primer mes.
Okay.
Pesach, Hag matzah, y Bikurim.
Those all happen in the first month.
Todos eso ocurren en el primer mes.
David Jr.
David.
Name me a holy day that happens in the second month.
Un día santo que ocurre en el segundo mes.
¿Qué? What holy day happens in the second month? What? Anybody? Dr. Mark? Pesach 2.
Pesach 2.
Yes, Pesach 2. If you've touched a dead thing.
Sí, el segundo Pesach, si tocas algo muerto.
And you can't celebrate it in the first month because you've touched a dead person.
Y no lo puedes celebrar en el primer mes porque tocaste una persona muerta.
Then you can celebrate it in the second month.
Entonces lo puedes celebrar en el segundo
mes. Yes, Ruthie. Yes, that's in Leviticus.
Eso está en Levítico.
Yeah.
Or in Exodus, sorry.
Oh, in Exodo.
Okay.
We read it.
Yes. If you've touched a dead person.
Si tocaste una persona muerta.
And you can't celebrate the Passover.
Entonces no puede celebrar el Pesaj.
Then you have to celebrate it 1 month later.
Entonces lo tiene que celebrar un mes después.
But you still have to celebrate it.
Pero todavía lo tiene que celebrar.
Is there any other one? Is there any other holy days in the second month? No, no other holy days in the second month. See?
So question. If you touch a dead person, you can't celebrate Pesach in the first month. You celebrate in the second month. But what about Hag Matzah and Bikurim?
You're not celebrating. Well, all depends what level of unclean you are.
But if you touch a dead person, what level of unclean are you?
Well, it all depends when you touch that dead person now, isn't it?
Could be.
Is it one day or is it until evening or this thing that... Whatever made you unclean, mm-hmm. whatever made you unclean,
lo que te haya hecho impuro,
that determines if you're going to miss Pesach or not.
Eso va a determinar si vas a faltar Pesach o no.
Okay, so you have to figure that out.
Okay.
So if you... The question would be better said.
La pregunta sería mejor dicha, preguntado.
Is those muffins look really good?
That's the question?
The question is better said, if you're unclean.
La pregunta sería mejor si eres impuro.
For Pesach.
Para Pesach.
You know, is it that you're missing that day?
¿Será que tú estás faltando ese día?
Okay, you know, is that the seventh day so that you can do matzah?
¿Será el séptimo día para que pueda hacer matzah?
Okay, so the reason we're talking about this,
la razón que estamos hablando sobre esto,
is because in Shemot, Exodus 19,
es que en Shemot, en Éxodo, capítulo
19, verse 1,
versículo 1,
we need to see that they're at the mountain,
que tenemos que ver si, que están en la montaña,
in the third month,
en el tercer mes.
So whether it's the first day or a few days after that,
pues aunque sea el primer día o un par de días después de eso,
we know that it's the third month.
Sabemos que es el tercer mes.
Since we left Egypt.
Desde que salimos de Egipto.
Okay. Now, verse 3 again.
Versículo 3 de nuevo.
Moshe went up to Elohim and Jehovah called to him from the mountain. Here's what you're to say to the household of Yaakov to tell the people of Israel. You see two people groups there.
Ves dos grupos de personas ahí.
Okay. You see the children of Yaakov.
Ves los hijos de Yaakov.
That would be me.
Eso sería
and the bee.
Nosotros.
Okay.
El rabino.
Okay.
Y yo.
And then you have the people of Israel.
Y entonces tienes el pueblo de Israel.
That would be the other people that were walking with them.
Eso sería las otras gente que estaba caminando con ellos.
Because everybody was invited to walk with Jehovah.
Porque todos fueron invitados a caminar con Jehovah.
When we left bondage,
cuando salimos de la esclavitud,
everybody was invited.
Todos fueron invitados.
Because we see earlier in the book of Shemot,
porque vemos más temprano en el libro de Éxodo,
that a mixed multitude left.
Que una multitud mixta salieron.
A mixed multitude not meaning men and women.
Una multitud mixta que no quiere decir hombre y mujer.
But to tell the people of Israel, meaning Am Yisrael.
Que decirle al pueblo de Israel, Am
now,
Israel.
What does Am Yisrael?
¿Qué quiere decir Am Yisrael?
You know, there's a song.
Hay una canción.
Am Yisrael Chai.
Am Yisrael Chai.
O Davidu Chai. O Davidu Chai. O Davidu, O Davidu, O Davidu Chai. Do you know what that means? Am Yisrael Chai.
Am Israel Chai.
The people of Yisrael live.
El pueblo de Israel vive.
The people of Yisrael live.
El pueblo
Am Yisrael,
de Israel.
Am people.
Am gente, pueblo.
Yisrael.
Israel.
Chai. Life.
Vida.
Am Yisrael Chai.
Am Israel Chai.
Okay. So here you have the people of Israel.
So aquí tienes el pueblo de Israel.
Walking with Jehovah.
Caminando con Jehovah.
So, this holy day that we're studying in the intermediate part here,
este día santo que estamos estudiando en la parte intermediario,
is going to be for anybody who wants to follow what God says.
Va a ser para aquel que quiere seguir lo que Dios dice.
But it's important to underline in your Bibles verse 1.
Pero es importante subrayar en sus Biblias el versículo 1.
Because you want to underline the third month.
Porque quieres subrayar el tercer mes.
And then you also want to underline the end of verse 3.
Y también el final de versículo 3.
God's going to tell the children of Jacob.
Dios le va a decir a los hijos de Jacob.
And he's also going to tell the people of Israel.
Y también le va a decir al pueblo de Israel.
He's going to tell them some instructions.
Le va a dar instrucciones.
Okay. Now, what those instructions are, we're going to go over tonight.
¿Qué quiere decir qué son esas instrucciones? Lo vamos a repasar esta noche.
Okay. But we need it. Yes, Ruthie, go ahead. It all depends
que todo depende
if you're unclean.
Si está impuro.
There's nowhere in Scripture where it says you then have to do Hag Matzah in the second month.
No hay en Escritura donde tiene que hacer Hag Matzah
or the Bikurim.
Or Bikurim.
But you must do Pesach.
Pero tienes que hacer Pesach.
Pesach is personal.
Pesach es personal.
Because you do it in your homes.
Porque lo hacen en sus hogares.
But the Bikurim,
pero el Bikurim
is done as a group.
Está hecho como un grupo.
Okay, it's a personal relationship.
Es una relación personal.
So there's Levitical and there's Torah laws.
Hay leyes de Torah.
That you're told that you must celebrate it in the second month.
Que está instruido que tienes que celebrarlo.
So say you're unclean.
So vamos a decir que está impuro.
Your husband sat on the bed with you.
Tu esposo se sentó en la cama contigo.
During your neidah.
Durante tu neidah.
Really, he shouldn't be celebrating the Pesach.
En verdad, él no debe de celebrar el Pesach.
Because he's ceremoniously unclean.
Porque está impío ceremonialmente.
But we've gone over all this.
Pero ya repasamos todo esto.
Okay. So, we can go over it again. I'll show you all the scripture references later.
Lo repasamos de nuevo.
Okay. Going on to the next slide for the tech department.
Ahora en la próxima página.
Shavuot, the Festival of Weeks.
Shavuot, el Festival de las Semanas.
Is the second set.
Es el segundo set.
Set. Anybody's? Grupo. Grupo, yeah.
El segundo grupo.
The three major festivals.
De los tres festivales mayores.
These festivals have historical and agricultural understandings.
Estos festivales tienen entendimiento historial y agricultural.
The other sets are the spring holy days.
El otro grupo son los días santos de la primavera.
Specifically Hag Matzah.
Específicamente Hag Matzah.
And then the fall holy day of Sukkot.
Y el festival del otoño que es Sukkot.
Historically,
historialmente,
this holy day
este día santo
celebrates the giving of the Torah to Am Yisrael.
Celebra la entrega del Torah a Am Israel, al pueblo de
it
Israel.
It is called Hag Matan Torateinu.
Se llama Hag Matan Torateinu.
Okay. The festival of giving of the Torah.
El festival de la entrega del Torah.
That's what Shavuot is all about.
De eso es lo que se trata Shavuot.
Okay. It's all about a giving of a contract.
Se trata de una entrega de un contrato.
If you go to our study about the biblical marriage.
Si vas a nuestro estudio de matrimonio bíblico.
The seven things needed for a biblical marriage.
Las siete cosas que se necesita para un matrimonio bíblico.
One of the things is called a ketubah.
Una de las cosas se llama un ketubah.
The ketubah is the contract.
El ketubah es el contrato.
That the husband gives to the wife.
Que el esposo le entrega a la esposa.
Saying, this is what I will provide for you.
Diciendo, esto es lo que voy a proveer por ti.
For our marriage.
Para nuestro matrimonio.
But what he does.
Pero lo que él hace.
Is he gives this pledge.
Es que él da esta promesa.
And then he goes away and he goes to prepare a home.
Y después él se va y prepara un hogar.
Okay. So Jehovah pledged to be our husband.
So Jehovah prometió ser nuestro esposo.
And he gave us Torah.
Y nos dio Torah.
Our contract.
Nuestro contrato.
Okay. So the more Hag Matan Torateinu.
So el Hag Matan Torateinu.
This is, we celebrate this each year.
Nosotros celebramos esto
cada año. Because those of us who love God.
Porque aquellos de nosotros que amamos a
love Dios, his word,
amamos su palabra,
should, with all of our heart, mind, soul, and strength, debemos, celebrate this day.
Debemos con toda nuestra fuerza, mente y corazón celebrar este día.
And those that don't celebrate this
y aquellos
day
que no celebran este día,
do not love God.
No aman a Dios.
You can say you love all you want.
Tú puedes decir que tú le amas todo lo que tú quieras.
But if you forget the day that you were married,
pero si te olvidas del día en que fuiste casado,
your wife's going to say, you're sleeping on the couch.
Tu esposa va a decir, estás durmiendo en el sofá.
You can't have none of this.
No puedes tener nada de esto.
You can go sleep in your car or something.
Tú puedes dormir en tu carro.
Okay? So, the Lord is wanting us,
el Señor quiere de nosotros,
to remember this day that He gave us life.
Que nos acordemos de este día en cual Él nos dio vida.
And in Exodus 19, verse 1,
en Éxodo capítulo 19, versículo 1,
this happens in the third month.
Esto ocurre en el tercer mes.
Not on the secular calendar of March.
No en el calendario secular de marzo.
In Jehovah's third month.
En el tercer mes de Jehová.
That's what you also need to remember.
Eso también necesitas entender, recordar.
And I highly recommend to everybody.
Y recomiendo sumamente a todo el mundo.
Start watching the moon.
Empiece a mirar la luna.
After what we saw this past week in France.
Después de lo que vimos esta última semana en Francia.
What Yeshua said in Matthew 24.
Lo que Yeshua dijo en Mateo capítulo 24.
Is going to be happening.
Va a ocurrir.
This is not stopping everybody.
Esto no va a parar.
This is a fight between kingdom versus kingdom.
Esto es una lucha entre reino contra reino.
And God is raising up these animals.
Y Dios está levantando estos animales.
Because this is a fight between him and Satan.
Porque esto es una lucha entre él y Satanás.
And he's allowing it.
Y él está permitiendo.
Because we don't love him.
Que ocurra porque nosotros no lo amamos.
You can say you love Jesus all you want, but if you're not doing his Shabbat, you don't love him.
Tú puedes decir que tú amas a Jesús todo lo que tú quieras. Pero si no está guardando su Shabbat, no lo amas.
There was an interesting report.
Había un reporte interesante.
You know, when this terrorist attack happened,
cuando este ataque terrorista ocurrió,
Madonna was on stage.
Madonna estaba en la tarima.
And you know what song she was singing?
¿Y sabes qué canción ella estaba cantando?
Kiss the Devil.
Besa al diablo.
When the terrorist attack happened,
cuando el ataque terrorista ocurrió,
she was singing Kiss the Devil.
Ella estaba cantando Besa al Diablo.
Well, y'all just did.
Well, toditos ustedes lo hicieron.
On Friday night.
El viernes en la noche.
This is just the beginning.
Esto es solamente el comienzo.
So know that we are in the ninth month, everybody.
Sepan que estamos en el noveno mes.
God's ninth month.
En el noveno mes de Dios.
And there's a very special event that happens this month.
Y hay un evento especial que ocurre este mes.
It is called the Feast of Dedication.
Se llama el Festival de Dedicación.
Or, in other words, Hanukkah.
O en otras palabras, Hanukkah.
And has absolutely nothing to do with oil lasting 8 days.
Y no tiene absolutamente nada que ver con el aceite durando 8 días.
It has everything to do with Hag Matan Torah Tenu.
Tiene todo que ver con Hag Matan Torah Tenu.
Because it's all about an altar.
Porque se trata todo de un altar.
Being rededicated.
Haciendo rededicado.
But how could you dedicate something?
Pero cómo puedes dedicar algo
that you don't know.
Que no conoces.
Okay. So the people, as we see in Exodus 19, verse 1.
So aquí como vemos en Éxodo capítulo 19, versículo 1.
That, let's read it again.
Vamos a leerlo de nuevo.
In the third month after the people of Israel had left the land of Egypt, the same day they came to the Sinai Desert. There's something very special that happens in the third month.
Hay algo bien especial que ocurre en el tercer mes.
I don't understand your question, Joanne. If you'd be more specific, I'll answer it. Okay. Going on to the next slide for the tech department.
Ahora vamos a la próxima página.
What we're talking about with Shavuot.
Lo que estamos hablando con Shavuot.
This is the culmination, the ending of.
Esta es la culminación, el término de.
Of a time of counting.
De un tiempo de contadeo.
Because you count the days from Bikurim,
porque cuentas los días de Bikurim,
primera fruta,
primeras frutas,
to Shavuot.
Ah, Shavuot.
And those of us who love Jehovah,
y aquellos de nosotros que amamos a Jehovah,
it is a time of great anticipation.
Es un tiempo de gran anticipación.
Because it's a countdown to this time of remembering.
Porque es un conteo a este tiempo de memoria.
Yes. It's, you know, I remember when you were children.
Acuerda cuando eran niños.
And all of you grew up not knowing Torah.
Y crecieron no conociendo a Torah.
Can you remember, you know, 30 days till, you know, my birthday.
¿Te acuerdas? 30 días hasta mi cumpleaños.
And you started to remind people.
Y empezaste a acordarle a las personas.
Remember my birthday is in a couple of weeks.
Acuérdate que mi cumpleaños es un par de semanas.
Or those of you who are Christian.
O aquellos que eran cristianos.
You know, for a Christmas, this is what I want.
Pero para Christmas, esto es lo que yo quiero, para la Navidad.
And you started dropping hints of what you wanted.
Y le estaba dando, este... dando pistas de lo que tú querías.
Now what God wants
y lo que Dios quiere
is you counting down the days to remember him giving the Torah.
Es que cuentes los días a donde a cuando él este entregó su Torah.
And that's what Shavuot is all about.
Y de eso lo que se trata Shavuot.
Shavuot is sometimes known by Gentiles as Pentecost.
Shavuot es conocido por los gentiles como Pentecostés.
Because it falls 50 days after the resurrection.
Porque cae 50 días después de la resurrección.
Now, why we're counting?
¿Por qué estamos contando?
It reminds us
nos acuerda
of our steps that we take with God.
De nuestros pasos que tomamos con Dios.
Each day you should take a step towards more obedience.
Cada día debe de tomar un paso para ser más obediente.
To God's word.
A la palabra de Dios.
And if somebody calls me legalistic,
y si alguien me llama legalístico,
I tell them thank you very much.
Yo le digo gracias.
I am very legalistic.
Yo soy bien legalístico.
Because so is my dad in heaven.
Porque también mi padre en el cielo.
Because each day I want to take one step closer.
Porque cada día yo quiero tomar un paso más cerca.
To following him better.
A seguirlo mejor.
And the time of the counting of the Omer.
Y el tiempo del el contadeo del Omer.
Well, what is counting of the Omer?
¿Qué es el contadeo del Omer?
That's counting the days from Bikurim, first fruits.
Eso es contando los días de Bikurim, de primeras frutas.
To Shavuot.
A Shavuot.
Okay? That's the counting of the Omer.
Ese es el contadeo del Omer.
Because what this time is,
porque lo que es este tiempo,
Shavuot is a time of remembering.
Shavuot es un tiempo de acordar.
Of how Pesach freed us from freedom of the law.
Como acordarnos de que Pesach nos liberó de la ley.
Yeah, we weren't under the law.
Nosotros no estábamos
when
bajo
we were
la
living
ley.
In Egypt, we were not under the law.
No, cuando estábamos en Egipto, no estábamos bajo la ley.
We were living under grace.
Estamos viviendo bajo gracia.
And when you live under grace,
y cuando vives bajo gracia,
you live under man-made rules.
Tú vives bajo las reglas de hombre.
When you live under law,
cuando vives bajo la ley,
you live under the best master's rules.
Tú vives bajo las leyes de las reglas del mejor amo.
And a king that laid his life down for his servant.
Y el rey que entregó su vida por su sirviente.
Would Fidel Castro lay his life down for one of his soldiers?
Fidel Castro entregaría la vida de él por uno de sus soldados.
Would the North Korean leader lay down his life for one of his soldiers?
El líder norcoreano entregaría su vida por otro soldado.
Would Vladimir Putin lay his life down for one of his Russian soldiers?
Vladimir Putin entregaría su vida por uno de sus soldados rusos.
Would the disgusting piece of garbage sitting in the White House lay his life down for anybody?
El pedazo de basura aborrente que está en la Casa Blanca entregaría su vida
por... The person that has no brains in the White House called Barack Hussein Obama.
Uno que no tiene cerebro que está en la Casa Blanca que
remember
se llama
to
Barack
use his full name.
Hussein Obama.
Because this, you know, that's a Muslim name.
Es un nombre musulmán.
So don't call him Obama.
No lo llames Obama.
Call him Barack Hussein Obama.
Llámalo Barack Hussein Obama.
Because he is not a Christian.
Porque él no es cristiano. Okay. And Fidel Castro won't give his life for one of his soldiers. He'll send him to Bolivia and have him killed.
Okay. Okay. So here, Pesach.
Aquí Pesach.
Freed us from the physicalness of bondage.
No, nos liberó de la esclavitud física.
But Shavuot.
Pero Shavuot.
Is the giving of Torah.
Es la entrega de Torah.
In the redemption of our spiritual lives.
Y la redención de nuestras vidas espirituales.
See, Torah teaches us
la Torah nos enseña
what real bondage is.
De qué es la verdadera esclavitud.
Shavuot reminds us
Shavuot nos acuerda
that we left idolatry,
que salimos de la idolatría,
and immorality,
y inmoralidad,
to walk with God.
A caminar con Dios.
And it's so sad,
y es tan triste,
that this holy day is not widely celebrated by everybody who knows Messiah.
Que este día no es celebrado alrededor de todos que conocen Mesías.
Many messianic congregations don't even get together.
Muchas congregaciones mesiánicas no se reúnen.
Oh, there's not many that do this, man.
No hay muchos que lo hacen.
You know, there's a real big one in Wayne.
Hay uno bien grande en Wayne.
Well, they're there on Sunday, but I really wouldn't call them messianic.
Ellos están verdaderamente ahí en los domingos, pero no se.
But they're not celebrating Shavuot.
Pero no están celebrando Shavuot.
Because their leader says, you know, do whatever your heart tells you.
Porque el líder de ellos le dice que haga todo lo que tu corazón te diga.
What I tell you,
lo que yo te digo,
is do what Torah tells you.
Es haz lo que Torah te diga.
And if you don't,
y si no lo haces,
you're a mamzer.
Eres un bastardo.
Okay, I didn't make the rules.
Yo no hice la regla.
I'm just, you know, just like my cousin Moses.
Como mi primo Moisés.
I'm just telling you the rules.
Solamente te estoy diciendo las reglas.
You know, you got a soul.
Tú tienes un alma.
And it's going to return back to God.
Y va a regresar a Dios.
And he's going to open the books.
Y va a abrir los libros.
And then the book.
Y después el libro.
And it's going to judge against y'all.
Y va. Y va a juzgar en contra de ustedes.
I'm not going to be your judge.
Yo no voy a ser tu juez.
Because if I were you, all be dead.
Porque si yo fuera tu juez, toditos estuvieran muertos.
No, it's like, we got to pull up the game, guys.
Tenemos que mejorar el juego.
We got to play all 60 minutes, unlike the Giants.
Tenemos que jugar.
Well, he did intercept that ball, and Cruz did catch it in the end zone. I had to get that in there. I got to watch a football game. Okay, so back to the study.
De regreso al estudio.
Going on to the next slide.
Ahora en la próxima página.
It, the other part about Shavuot.
La otra parte de Shavuot.
What you should think of it as.
Lo que debes de pensar, piénsalo como.
It is the time of giving of the Torah.
Es el tiempo de la entrega de Torah.
Not receiving.
No recibirla.
It is the day Jehovah gave us something.
Es el día que Jehovah nos dio algo.
He gave his bride her presence.
El Dios le dio a su novia su regalo.
And he said, this is how you can be a good bride to me.
Y él dijo, esto es como puede ser una buena novia para mí.
It is misunderstood when you say we receive the Torah.
Es mal entendido cuando se dice que recibimos la Torah.
Okay, it's not about us.
No se trata de nosotros.
Remember, it's about him.
Se trata de él.
He gave.
Él dio.
We received.
Nosotros recibimos.
And it should be remembered as him giving something.
Y se debe de acordar como que él nos dio algo.
Like when Yeshua gave his life.
Como cuando Yeshua dio, entregó su vida.
We received life abundantly.
Nosotros recibimos vida en abundancia.
But the word gave its life.
Pero el Dios dio su vida.
And when he gave us this life.
La palabra dio su vida, I'm sorry. Y cuando él entregó esta vida.
It is greatly significant to us.
Es bien significante.
And that's what makes Shavuot such a blessing.
Y eso De eso es lo que se trata, Shavuot siendo una gran bendición.
And significant.
I
can turn on the other camera so you can hear it in the other room if you want. Or if you want, it all depends what you want to do. Tristan, can you turn on the camera in the sanctuary? Cisco's going to go over to the Genesis room so that he can hear this, please. Thank you. But the key about Shavuot,
pero la clave de sobre Shavuot,
is that it does not have a set date.
Es que no tiene una fecha fija.
That is significant.
Eso es significante.
Pesach has a set date.
Pesach tiene una fecha fija.
Hagmatza has a set date.
Hagmatza tiene una fecha fija.
Bikurim does not.
Bikurim no tiene una fecha fija.
Okay. Yom Teruah has a set date.
Yom Teruah tiene una fecha fija.
Yom Kippur has a set date.
Yom Kippur tiene una fecha fija.
But in Sukkot has a set date.
Y Sukkot tiene una fecha fija.
But there are two holy days that do not have a set date.
Pero hay dos días santos que no tienen fecha fija.
Let's see. Adriana, since you're here, why do you think God made Shavuot not have a set date? Why do you think the day he gave us is...
Because it depends. You want to come from Bikurim.
No, but why?
Why?
Yeah, why? Oh, wow. Mm. You have... Want you to have an interest?
To make sure we count.
Okay. Benjamin?
To keep our eyes to heaven, watching the moon.
Keep our eyes to heaven.
To be alert.
En español.
Para ser atente. Mirar la luna y estar alerta. Alerta o alerto, dependiendo del...
Yes, you're correct, Joanne.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, I was just being funny.
It's about alertness.
Se trata de ser alerta.
It's about... See, when something doesn't have a set date...
¿Ves cuando algo no tiene fecha fija?
You have to be alert.
Tú tienes que estar alerta.
You have to be aware.
Tú tienes que estar atento.
And it's vitally important to God.
Y es sumamente importante para Dios.
Who of my children is going to be alert?
¿Cuáles de mis hijos va a estar atento?
Who of my children is going to care?
¿Cuál de mis hijos le va a importar?
That's what's so important.
Eso es lo que es tan importante.
See, because the reason it changes.
Porque la razón que cambia.
Because if Pesach is on a Monday.
Porque si Pesach es un lunes.
Then you have Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
Entonces tiene martes, miércoles, jueves, viernes, sábado.
Until you get to the Bikurim.
Hasta que llegues al Bikurim.
But then the next year,
pero el próximo año,
maybe Pesach falls on a Friday.
Tal vez Pesach caiga un viernes.
So the date changes.
So la fecha cambia.
But the time frame does not.
Pero el cuadro de tiempo no cambia.
But it's set on a certain, it's set on the Bikurim.
Porque está puesto en el Bikurim.
It's set on that first day of the week when you start your Omer counting.
Está puesto en el primer día de la semana cuando tú empieces a contar tu Omer.
Yom Teruah
no tiene fecha fija.
Sí, it does.
Yes, lo tiene.
But it's still going to be the first day of the seventh month.
Pero todavía va a ser el primer día del séptimo mes.
Right?
¿Verdad?
Is Yom Teruah in the scriptures? Yes. Vayikra 23.
Yes, but it says to watch it's on the new moon.
Yes, it'll always be on the new moon, which is the first day of the month.
Siempre va a estar en la luna nueva, que es el primer día del mes. Rosh Kadesh.
Sí. Ken. Yes. Amen. It only took 3 years. But I'll take that. you're better than most Christians. And sadly enough, a fair amount of Messianics. Okay? So let's move on to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
Now, the reason I spent so much time on that,
la razón que pasé tanto tiempo en eso,
because in this next slide,
porque en esta próxima
I'll read it and then Ben could mutilate it, I mean, translate it. Understanding the rabbinic madness so that you don't stray to man-made madness. You'll be able to discern and stay on the narrow path.
Entendiendo la locura rabínica para que no te desvíes a la locura hecho por hombre, vas a poder discernir y quedar, mantenerte en el camino estrecho.
See, we teach the Torah here.
Aquí enseñamos la Torah.
We don't teach Talmud.
No enseñamos Talmud.
We don't teach Kabbalah.
No enseñamos Kabbalah.
We don't teach the Zohar.
No enseñamos el Zohar.
And anybody that's in those areas really is lost.
Y aquellos que estén en esas áreas, en verdad, están perdidos.
There is enough in Torah to keep you busy.
Hay suficiente en Torah para mantenerte ocupado.
Okay, but we're going to look at a little bit of rabbinic stuff here.
Lo que vamos a mirar ahora es cosas rabínicas.
Because I need you to understand.
Porque necesito que entiendan.
Why sometimes it gets confusing here.
Porque a veces se pone un poco confuso aquí.
Because people go, well, the Jews are doing it on this day.
Pero hay gente que dicen que los judíos lo están haciendo en este
día. Why are you guys doing it on another day?
¿Por qué ustedes lo están haciendo en otro día?
Well, in rabbinic tradition,
en tradición rabínico,
the Jews start counting the Omer.
Los judíos comienzan a contar el Omer.
On the second night of Passover.
En la segunda noche de Pesach.
Can somebody please tell me?
Alguien me podrá decir a mí.
Ruthie, you're a pretty smart woman.
Ruthie, tú eres una mujer.
Could you please tell me where the second night of Passover is?
¿Me puedes decir cuándo es la segunda noche de Pesach?
Dr. Mark, you're a doctor, so maybe you're a pretty smart guy. It doesn't exist.
No existe, dice Dr. Mark.
Are you sure?
¿Estás seguro?
But like all those Jews in New York are doing this.
Pero todos los judíos en Nueva York lo están haciendo.
My mother used to say to me, "Are you coming for a second night of Passover?"
Mi mamá me preguntaba que si yo venía para la segunda noche de Pesaj.
Tell her there is no second night of Passover.
Yo le decía a ella que no hay segunda noche de Pesaj.
But this is what happens when you don't follow the Torah.
Pero esto es lo que sucede cuando uno no sigue la Torah.
Then you're not celebrating Shavuot on the right day.
Entonces no está celebrando a Shavuot en el día correcto.
See, if the bickering, the Omer always started.
Si el Omer siempre comenzó
on the second night of Passover,
en la segunda noche de Pesach,
wouldn't then Shavuot have a set day?
Entonces Shavuot no tendría un día fijo.
Like if the second night of Passover is the 15th,
como si la segunda noche de Pesach es el 15,
wouldn't then
entonces no
Shavuot be a set day?
No sería Shavuot. Tendría una fecha fija.
What do you think about that, David Jr.?
¿Qué piensas ahí, David Jr.?
Huh? I got now froofy heads underneath. Okay? So it would have a set day.
So tendría una fecha fija.
Then why do we have to count?
So entonces, ¿por qué tenemos que contar?
If it's a set day, then I don't gotta count.
Si es un día fijo, entonces no tengo que contar.
I just look on my phone and it's gonna tell me what day.
Solo miro mi teléfono y dice, me va a decir cuál día es.
Because there it is.
Porque ahí está.
Okay. That's going loud. On to the next slide.
That's loud. Ahora en la próxima página.
Okay. Torah says it is very simple.
La Torah dice que es bien simple.
If you follow Torah,
si sigues a Torah,
you won't get lost.
No te perderás.
Turn to Leviticus 23.
Vamos a Levítico capítulo 23.
Verse 10 and 11.
Y 11.
They were practicing this all last night. And the girl still is flat.
She hurts my feelings every time she gets on the microphone. She really does.
Well, that's NESB. It's 136 in the CJB. Leviticus, Vayikra 23, verse 10 and 11.
Leviticus, capítulo 23, versículos 10 y 11.
Hmm? Yeah. When you got it, say amen. Everybody got it?
Cuando lo tengan, digan amén.
Got it, Frank?
Yeah, I got it from there, too.
I'm waiting for Frank. He's going to say it. Leviticus, you're way past it. Oh, you got a Hebrew Bible.
He's got the Hebrew Bible.
Okay, Leviticus 23, verse 10 and 11.
Leviticus, capítulo 23, versículos 10 y 11.
Tell the people of Israel, after you enter the land I'm giving you, and harvest its ripe crops, you're to bring a sheaf of first fruits of your harvest to the Kohen. He is to wave the sheaf before Jehovah, so that you will be accepted. The Kohen is to wave it on the day after Shabbat. Okay, so it says the day after Shabbat.
Dice el día después de Shabbat.
When is the Shabbat?
¿Cuándo es el Shabbat?
The seventh day.
El séptimo día.
It's always the seventh day.
Siempre es el séptimo día.
Okay. The holy day is the holy day.
El día santo es el día santo.
Okay. And Shabbat is always the seventh day.
Y Shabbat es siempre el séptimo día.
So you're to bring the sheaf for waving.
So tienes que traer la gavilla para mecer.
On the day after Shabbat.
En el día después de Shabbat.
So when would that be, Jorge?
So cuando sería eso, Jorge?
Would that be like our Tuesday?
Eso sería martes.
Sunday.
Domingo.
The first
primer
day of the week.
Día de la semana.
Okay. So I don't know why that's so hard to understand.
No sé por qué eso es tan difícil entender.
I don't know how the rabbis, without smoking a serious amount of marijuana.
No sé si los rabinos estaban fumando una cantidad seria de marihuana.
Okay. Can't see this.
No pueden ver eso. Maybe they were eating hashish cookies.
Hashish cookies, yes.
Brownies.
Brownies, maybe. Or croissants laced with marijuana.
Hashish croissants.
Okay, so here it's very important,
so aquí es bien importante,
for you to know this,
para saber esto,
because you'll start getting deeper into wanting to follow Torah.
Porque vas a querer profundizarte más en Torah.
And like you saw, the young man is here this past week.
Y como viste aquí este joven que estaba aquí esta última semana.
He swung so far.
Él se fue tan lejos.
Because a lot of people want to be Jewish so badly.
Porque hay gente que quieren ser judíos tan y tan tanto.
That they see something.
Ellos ven algo.
And they do something.
Y ellos hacen algo.
Okay, I'll tell you everything I do.
Yo te digo todo lo que yo hago.
I'll be able to point you to chapter and verse.
Te puedo dirigir a capítulo y versículo.
In the Torah.
En el Torah.
Okay. And for Hanukkah,
y para Hanukkah,
I'll point to the Brit Hadashah.
Te señalo en el Brit Hadashah.
In John chapter 10, verse 22.
Juan capítulo 10, versículo 22.
And then I'll go to 2 Chronicles 7.
Y después voy a segundo libro de Crónicas, capítulo 7.
So, why I'm making a very strong point of this,
so porque yo estoy haciendo un punto fuerte a esto.
Because even at some Messianic congregations,
porque hasta en algunas congregaciones mesiánicas,
who are Talmudic with a little Yeshua cherry,
que son talmúdicos con un poco de cereza de Yeshua,
they will do second night of Passover.
Ellos practican la segunda noche de Pesach.
They will not do,
ellos no hacen,
what you see here in verse 11.
Lo que ves aquí en el versículo 11.
Okay. There's not many like this congregation.
No hay muchos como esta congregación.
Okay? And it's sad to say.
Y es bien triste decirlo.
Okay? I see it, I do it.
Lo veo, lo hago.
I teach it.
Lo enseño.
Okay? So here in verse 11,
so aquí en el versículo 11,
he is to wave the sheep before Jehovah so that you will be accepted. The Kohen is to wave it on the day after Shabbat. Anybody here? Do you need me to turn the sound up?
Todo el mundo puede escuchar. ¿Quieren que
everybody
sube
okay?
El volumen?
Okay, because Well, are you being able to? Okay, well, it really doesn't come, what I've been told is it doesn't really come, because the lavaliers do not go very far. I just want to know if you guys can hear and hear.
Ustedes pueden escucharnos.
Maybe one day we'll own the building. And then people will be dismissed.
Baruch Hashem.
Okay.
Then we'll have different classrooms.
Absolutely. All right. And the way the congregation is growing. All right, going on to the next slide.
Ahora la próxima página.
Verse 5, Leviticus 23.
Leviticus capítulo 23.
Verse 5.
Versículo 5.
In the first month, on the 14th day of the month, between sundown and complete darkness, comes Pesach for Jehovah. Okay? It's very important to know that we do Pesach in the first month.
Es bien importante saber que hacemos Pesach en el primer mes.
And the reason we're talking about this,
y la razón en que estamos hablando sobre esto,
in the Hebrew it doesn't say Shabbat Pesach.
En el hebreo no dice Shabbat Pesach.
It just says Pesach.
Solamente dice Pesach.
Okay? It's not a Shabbat.
No es un Shabbat.
Why isn't it a Shabbat?
¿Por qué no es un Shabbat?
What's the difference? You got to cook.
Tienes que cocinar.
You got to light a fire.
Tienes que encender
so
un fuego.
Here's how you checkmate a rabbi real fast.
So, así es que le haces jaque mate a un rabino bien rápido.
Okay? Okay. You're saying second night of Passover?
¿Está diciendo segunda noche de Pesach?
It's a Shabbat.
Es un Shabbat.
What are you supposed to do on Passover?
¿Qué estás supuesto a hacer en Pesach?
What do you do on that day?
¿Qué haces en ese día?
You make an offering.
Hace una ofrenda.
How am I going to make an offering if it's a Shabbat?
¿Cómo puedo hacer una ofrenda si es Shabbat?
In my home.
En mi casa.
Because Passover is supposed to be done in your home.
Porque Pesach está supuesto ser hecho en tu hogar.
Jaque mate. A one move checkmate.
Jaque mate de una sola movida.
So, Passover is Passover.
Pesach es Pesach.
It's very important to know that.
Es bien importante saber eso.
So that you celebrate the marriage, the giving of Torah.
Para que celebres el matrimonio, la entrega de Torah.
On the right day.
En el día correcto.
Okay. Everybody understand that.
Todos entienden eso.
Okay. And Pesach is on the 14th day at sundown.
Y Pesach es en el día 14 a la caída del sol.
Dusk to sundown.
De la tarde a la caída del sol.
Sí.
De la atardecer a la caída del sol.
You understand that, Frank? Pregunta? It's okay. It's Bible study.
It's about 90 minutes, right?
90 minutes.
Es 90 minutos. Solamente el periodo de Pesach. Es 90 minutos.
Yeah, Rav Will does it in 90 minutes. He's got the fire going.
Él tiene el fuego ya hecho.
Your fire is already like blazing hot.
El fuego ya está sumamente caliente.
Okay. No.
No. Porque tú, you have to, tiene que tener.
If you're going to put it on the fire.
Tiene que tener el cordero en tu casa por
like
cuatro
they,
días.
They have a farm.
Por cuatro
they have
días.
A farm. So yeah. they get the lamb 4 days before.
Ellos buscan el cordero 4 días antes.
Sometimes a little bit earlier because they have to.
Tal vez un poquito más temprano porque tiene que
but then. He's already got the fire going.
Pero ya él tiene el fuego hecho.
And at dusk,
y al atardecer,
he goes over, takes the lamb out.
Él va y saca el cordero.
The lamb goes, hey, where are we going?
El caldero dice, ¿para dónde vamos?
You're going to heaven.
Tú vas para el cielo.
And he takes him over by where the altar is.
Y él lo lleva al lado del altar.
Slits the lamb's throat.
Le corta el cuello, lo degolla.
Cuts him open.
Lo abre.
You know? Shears it, you know, the whole nine.
Lo despeluza.
And cooks it, and they eat it in 90 minutes.
Y lo cocina y se lo comen en 90 minutos.
Okay, it is better marinated.
Es
much
mejor,
better.
Sazonado.
Yes, 4 days without defect.
They're tearing up Michael W. Smith's song. Let It Rain?
That's it.
Oh, man, that's such a great song.
Well.
they're tearing it.
It's in Exodus.
It's in Exodus.
Yes.
It's in Exodus.
Exodus 12.
Exodus capítulo 12. Write it down.
All right. Going on to the next slide.
Ahora la próxima página.
Let's turn to Acts chapter 2, verse 1.
Vamos a Hechos capítulo 2, versículo 1.
While I make the sound a little bit louder.
Mientras yo hago el sonido un poquito más alto.
Oh, all righty, I'm back. Can you hear now better?
Oh, yeah.
Acts chapter 2.
It sounds like we're in a sound tunnel.
Acts chapter 2.
Hechos capítulo 2.
Acts chapter 2.
Hechos capítulo 2.
Verse 1 through 8.
Versículos 1 al 8.
Hey, Tristan, turn it down a little bit.
Yeah.
I made it a little too loud.
Croissant.
Acts chapter 2, verse 1 through 8.
Hechos capítulo 2, versículos 1 al 8.
Let's read it.
Vamos a leerlo.
The festival of Shavuot arrived, and the believers all gathered together in one place. Suddenly there came a sound from the sky like the roar of a violent wind, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting. Then they saw what looked like tongues of fire, which separated and came to rest on each one of them. They were all filled with the Ruach HaKodesh and began to talk in different languages, as the Spirit enabled them to speak. Now there were staying in Jerusalem religious Jews from every nation under heaven. When they heard this sound, a crowd gathered. They were confused, because each one heard the believers speaking in his own language. Totally amazed, they asked, "How is this possible? Aren't all these people who are speaking from the Galil? How is it that we hear them speaking in our native language?" Amen?
Amen.
All right. Now, did you know the Americans were there?
¿Tú sabías que los americanos estaban ahí?
The Americans were there.
Los americanos estaban ahí.
The American Indians were there.
Los indios americanos estaban ahí.
Because remember, Solomon sent ships all the way here.
Pero acuérdate que Salomón envió naves hasta aquí.
And the rock in New Mexico proves that the Torah came to America over 2,000 years ago.
Y la piedra de que se encontró en Nuevo México comprueba que la Torah había llegado aquí 3,000 years.
It's I just want to say for argument's sake, over 2,000.
Oh, más de 2,000 años.
Okay.
Sí.
So, key points before we go back to Torah.
Puntos claves antes de que regresemos a Torah.
I wanted you to notice verse 2.
Quiero que prestes atención al versículo 2.
There came a sound from the sky like the roar of a violent wind.
Vino un sonido desde el cielo como un viento recio.
Okay. In verse 3,
en el versículo 3,
tongues of fire.
Lenguas de fuego.
Tongues of fire.
Lenguas de fuego.
Then verse 4,
y versículo 4,
different languages.
Lenguas diferentes.
Verse 5,
versículo 5,
religious Jews from every nation under heaven.
Judíos religiosos de cada nación bajo el cielo.
That's the main points we want to take from the Brit Hadashah for right now.
Esos son los puntos claves que queremos agarrar del Brit Hadashah por ahora.
Okay. That now we're going to go back to Exodus 19.
Y ahora vamos a regresar a Éxodos capítulo 19.
But I wanted us to see
Pero queríamos que viéramos
the Brit Hadashah first.
El Brit Hadashah primero.
To remind you what we spoke about last week.
Para acordarte de lo que hablamos la semana pasada.
Now go on to the next slide.
Ahora vamos a la próxima página.
Why is Shavuot so important to Jehovah?
¿Por qué Shavuot es tan importante a Jehovah?
Now we're going to see why everybody was invited to his wedding.
Ahora vamos a ver por qué todos fueron invitados a su boda.
How many people want to be invited to the wedding of the Lamb?
¿Cuántos quieren ser invitados a la boda del Cordero?
Well, you might want to know when this day is.
Tal vez quisiera saber cuándo este día es.
Remember, Yeshua fulfilled the first 3 holy days.
Acuérdate que Yeshua cumplió con los primero 3 días santos.
And the Ruach HaKodesh came on Shavuot.
Y el Ruach HaKodesh vino en Shavuot.
Okay. It is this day that he gave us his marriage contract.
Es este día que él entregó su contrato de matrimonio.
Let's now study this day.
Ahora vamos a estudiar este día.
So that we can go witness to those downstairs that
so entonces
are not
podemos
going
testificarle
to
a aquellos allá abajo. Right?
Huh?
Uh-huh.
They're not going.
Yeah.
They're nice people, but they ain't doing this day. Remember what it said in the book of Revelation.
Acuérdate lo que dijo en el libro de Apocalipsis.
The books are open.
Los libros están abiertos.
And then the book of life.
Y después el libro de la vida.
So how do you think they're going to weigh out?
So cómo tú crees que van a medir?
How do you think your life's going to weigh out?
¿Cómo tú crees que tu vida va a medir?
Exodus 19.
Éxodo capítulo 19.
Verse 1, 2, 3 again.
Versículos 1, 2 y el 3. Nuevamente.
In the third month, after the people of Israel had left the land of Egypt, the same day they came to the Sinai Desert. After they set out from Rephidim and arriving at the Sinai Desert, they set up camp in the desert, there in front of the mountain. Israel set up camp. Moshe went up to Elohim, and Jehovah called to him from the mountain. Here's what you are to say to the household of Yaakov to tell the people of Israel. Okay, let's do a little bit of math, Gigi.
Vamos a ver, hacer un poco de matemática.
No, you don't want to do it. Brandy! math. Math is such a fine thing to do as she runs away. All right. Now, in the third month.
En el tercer mes.
Now, when do we do Passover?
¿Cuándo hacemos Pesach?
On the 14th day of the first month.
En el día 14 del primer mes.
In a month is how many days generally with the Lord?
Y generalmente, ¿cuántos días dura un mes con el Señor?
Anywhere from 28 and a half to 30 days.
Alrededor de 28 y medio a 30 días.
A lunar cycle is 28 and a half days.
Un ciclo lunar es 28 días y medio.
Okay, so you have in verse 1.
So aquí tenemos en el versículo 1.
You have the third month.
Tienes el tercer mes.
So at minimum.
So a mínimo.
The first day in a month.
El primer día del mes.
Would be how many days after Passover?
Sería cuánto,
Mr. B for.
¿Cuántos días de?
57 days. Public school. How many days in a month?
¿Cuántos días en un mes?
28 to 30. Let's just put it at 30.
Vamos a dejarlo a 30.
So we celebrate Pesach.
Celebramos Pesach.
And we left Egypt.
Y salimos de Egipto.
On the 15th day of the month.
En el día 15 del mes.
How many more days left in month 1? 15.
15 días sobran en el.
Then we have month 2.
Después tenemos el segundo
mes. Which
is
how many days?
Que son cuántos días?
30 days. So we're now at how many days?
So ahora cuántos días tenemos?
45. So here we're now in the third month.
So ahora estamos en el tercer mes.
So we have that reference point.
So tenemos ese punto de referencia.
Okay. So we're at least 45 days.
So por lo menos a 45 días.
43 to 45 days.
De 43 a 45 días.
After we left Mitzrayim.
Después que salimos de Mitzrayim, de Egipto.
Okay. So it would be interesting,
será interesante,
but unprovable,
pero no se puede comprobar,
if it was 1 week till Shavuot,
que fuera una semana hasta Shavuot,
to get ready for the Shavuot,
para prepararse para Shavuot.
Okay, the reason is,
la razón es,
And why you want to know this?
Porque quieran saber esto.
Because Acts chapter 2 verse 1 says what?
Porque Hechos capítulo 2 versículo 1 dice qué?
And the feast of Shavuot came.
Y el festival de Shavuot llegó.
So it's tying together with the third month.
So está enlazándose con el tercer mes.
Okay, it's very important to understand that.
Es bien importante entender eso.
Because everything's going to line up for this contract.
Porque todo se va a alinear para este contrato.
And everything else that occurs,
y todo lo demás que va a ocurrir,
has to be set on this first part.
Tiene que caer con esta primera parte.
Exodus 19 verse 1 says what?
Éxodo capítulo 19 versículo 1 dice qué?
Is that it is the third month.
Que es el tercer mes.
If in Acts chapter 2 verse 1,
si en Hechos capítulo 2 versículo 1,
it says Shavuot,
dice Shavuot,
we know it's 50 days after.
Sabemos que es 50 días después.
Okay, after Yeshua rose from the grave,
después que Yeshua resucitó de la tumba,
in Acts chapter 2 verse 1, we know it's 50 days after that point.
En Hechos capítulo 2 versículo 1, sabemos que es 50 días después de que resucitó.
Going on to the next line.
Ahora vamos a la próxima página.
We're now going to look at verse 4 through 6.
Ahora vamos a mirar al versículo 4 al 6.
You have seen what I did to the Egyptians and how I carried you on eagle's wings and brought you to myself. Now if you'll pay careful attention to what I say and keep my covenant, then you will be my own treasure from among all the people, for all the earth is mine. And you will be a kingdom of Kohanim for me, a nation set apart. These are the words you are to speak to the people of Israel. Okay? Now we're going to look at a couple of key areas.
Vamos a mirar a un par de áreas clave.
The first part is in verse 4.
La primera parte es en el versículo 4.
He's saying, see what I did to the Egyptians.
Él está diciendo, mira lo que yo he hecho con los egipcios.
When you don't want to follow the Lord,
cuando no quieres seguir al Señor,
he gives you an opportunity to walk with him.
Él te da una oportunidad para caminar con él.
But Pharaoh didn't want to do that.
Pero el faraón no quiso hacer eso.
So the Feast of Shavuot,
so el festival de Shavuot,
reminds us each year,
nos acuerda cada año,
of those steps that we took,
de esos pasos que tomamos,
away from freedom,
fuera de libertad,
and away from the law,
y fuera de la ley,
to walk with the law,
para caminar con la ley.
Because God separates those who walk with him,
porque Dios separa aquellos que caminan con él,
from the ISIS members,
de los miembros de ISIS.
And if you are not following Torah,
y si no estás siguiendo Torah,
and believing in Yeshua,
y creyendo en Yeshua,
you're as good as an ISIS member to God.
Eres igual que un miembro de ISIS a Dios.
You can't say that.
Tú no puedes decir eso.
I just did.
Ya, sí lo hice ya.
I'm legalistic.
Yo soy legalístico.
Thank you very much.
Muchas gracias. And,
okay.
And we're a sect.
Huh?
And we're a sect.
Yes.
Yeah. And our leader, Yeshua.
Okay. Now if we look at verse 5,
ahora si miramos al versículo 5,
now if you pay careful attention to what I say and keep my covenant, then you'll be my own treasure from among all the peoples, for all the earth is mine. Okay? Now, if you want Shavuot,
ahora si quieres Shavuot,
is teaching us
nos estás enseñando
to pay careful attention
para prestar cuidadosamente atención.
With every step that you take,
con cada paso que tomas,
every breath you make,
cada respiro que tomes,
God's going to be watching you.
Dios te va a estar mirando. Great song.
Yes, God wrote it. Okay? So, here it is. Shavuot is a reminder.
So aquí es que Shavuot es un acordatorio.
And the key word here in verse 5,
y la palabra clave aquí en el versículo 5,
is the word then.
Es la palabra then.
Then, T-H-E-N.
Oh, entonces.
Entonces. Okay? Then.
Entonces.
If you pay careful attention,
si presta atención
and keep my covenant,
y mantiene mi pacto,
then you're a treasure.
Entonces eres un tesoro.
But if you don't,
pero si no,
you're No better than a Muslim.
No, no eres mejor que un musulmán.
Okay. Okay. Now, paying careful attention.
Ahora prestando mucha atención.
Why does God say careful attention?
¿Por qué Dios dice prestando mucha atención?
Because it can't be sloppy with your marriage contract.
Porque no puede ser descuidado con tu contrato de matrimonio.
Well, I'm sorry, wife.
Oh, perdóname, esposa.
But she was a pretty prostitute, says Charlie Sheen.
Pero ella era una prostituta bonita, dijo Charlie Sheen.
You hear he has HIV.
Yeah. He made it.
All the money and fame didn't make him happy.
Que todo el dinero y la fama no lo puede salvar.
See, if you follow God,
si sigues a Dios,
and you keep pure in your marriage,
y te mantienes puro en tu matrimonio,
then these type of things don't happen to you.
Entonces estas cosas no suceden.
If you pay careful attention to your marriage to God,
si prestara mucha atención con tu matrimonio a Dios,
He won't make you sick.
Él no te va a hacer enfermo.
That's a promise.
Es una promesa.
If you pay careful attention,
si prestas mucha atención,
it's not enough.
No es suficiente.
Shavuot reminds us of a covenant.
Shavuot nos acuerda de un pacto.
Then you become a treasure.
Entonces te vuelves tesoro.
But only if you're remembering your marriage contract.
Solamente si te acuerdas de tu contrato de matrimonio.
And that's why there's no date on Shavuot.
Y por eso que no hay fecha en Shavuot.
You have to be careful how you count.
Tienes que tener cuidado cómo cuentas.
Then verse 6.
Y entonces versículo 6.
And you will be in a kingdom of Kohanim for me, a nation set apart. These are the words you are to speak to the people of Israel. Verse 6 speaks about becoming a nation.
Versículo 6 habla de convertirse en una nación.
So what would the nation constitute?
De qué se constituyera
esa nación. Not just the men.
No solamente los hombres.
The women are included.
También las mujeres están incluidas.
The children are included.
Los niños están incluidos.
You'll be a nation set apart.
Será una nación apartado.
You'll be royalty.
Right? Será realidad.
That's what Shavuot is about.
De eso lo que se trata Shavuot.
That's why you got to count the days.
Por eso que tú tienes que contar los días.
That's why you have to cite the moon.
Por eso que tú tienes que citar la luna.
That's why you have to walk the footsteps.
Por eso que tú tienes que caminar los pasos.
Mm-hmm.
For 40 days. That was last week, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Durante el contadeo del Omer, Yeshua caminó con los discípulos después de que resucitó.
And if hold your place in Exodus,
mantén tu lugar en Éxodo,
and turn to Acts chapter 1 verse 40, we'll go to what Adriana just talked about.
Vamos a Hechos capítulo 1 versículo 30.
1:4.
O 4, versículo 4.
Yeah, I said 40. 1:4.
Hechos capítulo 1 versículo 4.
Acts chapter 1.
Hechos capítulo 1.
Acts chapter 1.
Hechos capítulo 1.
Verse 4.
Versículo 4.
At one of these gatherings, he instructed them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait for what the Father promised, which you heard about from me. Why is he saying that?
¿Por qué él está diciendo esto?
Because he had been with them 40 days.
Porque él estaba con ellos 40 días.
And he's speaking about in verse 4.
Y él está hablando en el versículo 4.
The promise.
De la promesa.
The promise that we just read about in Exodus 19.
De la promesa que terminamos de leer en Éxodo capítulo 19.
How many Gentiles were in the crowd when Yeshua said these words?
¿Cuántos gentiles estaban en la multitud cuando Yeshua dijo estas palabras?
Zero. And the church was not born on this day.
Y la iglesia no nació en este día.
See, this is the sad part because they don't study the word of God, the church.
Esta es la parte triste porque ellos no estudian la palabra de Dios.
This was a confirmation.
Esto fue una confirmación.
And this is, I'm not talking Catholic confirmation.
Y no estoy hablando confirmación católico.
Because what Yeshua is talking about in verse 4,
porque de lo que Yeshua está hablando en el capítulo, en el versículo 4,
is that God promised.
Es que Dios prometió.
That if you keep your marriage contract,
que si mantienes tu contrato de matrimonio,
you will be a nation set apart.
Será una nación apartado.
A nation set apart.
Una nación apartada.
If you keep this holy day.
Si mantienes este día santo.
But you can't keep this holy day.
Pero no puedes guardar este día santo.
If you don't do the other ones.
Si no haces los otros.
You see how everything is tied together.
Ves como todo está enlazado.
That you must know when Pesach is.
Que debes de saber cuándo es Pesach.
But if you don't know when the new moon is,
pero si no sabes cuándo es la nueva luna,
you can't know when Pesach is.
No puedes saber cuándo es Pesach.
You can't know when the Bikurim is.
No puedes saber cuándo es el Bikurim.
You don't know when Shavuot is.
No sabes cuándo es Shavuot.
Because then you don't get your contract.
Porque entonces no recibes el contrato.
Because you didn't do your promises.
Porque no hiciste las promesas.
Because you didn't pay careful attention.
Porque no prestaste atención.
To God's covenant.
Al pacto de Dios.
And then you're like an Egyptian.
Y después eres como un egipcio.
A pagan.
Un pagano.
That's hard to hear.
Es duro escuchar.
For all those years that you thought you were following Jesus.
Por todos esos años que creías que estabas siguiendo a Jesús.
God thought of you as an Egyptian.
Dios te miró como si fuera egipcio.
A pagan. A pagan.
Un pagano.
The rules are the rules.
Las reglas son las reglas.
They're not just there for God felt like talking.
No están ahí simplemente porque Dios le quería hablar.
God wanted to give us his bride, the contract.
Dios quería darnos su novia, el contrato.
So he spoke the contract.
So él habló el contrato.
And he said, here.
Y él dijo, toma.
Accept it if you want.
Acéptalo si quieres.
And we'll get to that.
Y llegaremos a eso.
We'll get to that.
That's the promise that every Christian expects.
Yes, Adriana is talking about.
Adriana está hablando sobre,
like Frank learned at the institute,
como Frank aprendió en el instituto,
that you know you'll get baptized in the Holy Spirit,
que va a ser bautizado en el Espíritu Santo.
These ignoramuses that can't even get the Sabbath right don't even know anything about the Bible.
Estos ignorantes que no saben, no pueden ni hacer el Shabbat correcto, no saben nada de la Biblia.
And the reason I use such strong language,
y la razón por qué uso tan lenguaje fuerte,
because being nice doesn't seem to work.
Porque el ser bueno no parece que no funciona.
If you read the book of Kings or Chronicles,
si lees los libros de Reyes o Crónicas,
you see we go good for a little while.
Ves que estamos bien por un corto tiempo.
And it lasts 50 to 70 years.
Y dura entre 50 y 70 años.
And then all hell happens.
Y después todo lo malo ocurre.
How long has it been since World War II?
¿Cuánto tiempo ha sido desde la Segunda Guerra
Mundial? About 70 years.
Como 70 años.
And now we're looking at another world war coming very shortly.
Y estamos mirando ahora otra guerra mundial que va a ocurrir pronto.
And the reason is,
y la razón es,
because we're worried about people's feelings instead of about their souls.
Porque nos preocupamos de los sentimientos de los demás en vez de sus almas.
If everybody, you know, back in the 1950s,
si todos en los 1950,
you know, you would say, oh, don't talk to her, she's divorced.
Oh, no vaya donde ella, ella es divorciada.
Now it's, you're only on your first marriage?
Ahora es solamente está en tu primer matrimonio.
I'm on like my eighth marriage.
Yeah, yo estoy en mi octavo matrimonio.
When you move the boundary stone.
Cuando mueves la piedra frontera,
then all hell begins to happen.
Entonces sucede todo lo malo.
And you can't see logic.
Y no puedes ver la lógica.
What France should have done,
lo que Francia hubiera hecho,
is not bomb Syria.
Es no bombardear a Siria.
They should have blown up every mosque in their country.
Ellos deberían de haber bombardear cada mezquita en su país.
And all they have to do is look in their own history.
Y lo que tienen que hacer es mirar en su propia historia.
France used to have a good military back in the 1400s.
En los 1400 Francia tenía una buena milicia.
Islam had taken over Europe.
Islam se había apoderado de Europa.
It took over Spain.
Se apoderó de España.
You know who started the Crusades?
¿Sabes quién comenzó las cruzadas?
France.
Francia.
And the guy who is the mastermind of the bombing that happened the other day?
Y ahora el genio del bombardeo los otros días?
His name is the same as the person that began to lose when France hit them in the 1400s.
El nombre de él es igual a la persona que empezó a perder cuando Francia se apoderó en los 1400.
And it all comes because we forgot our God.
Y todo está ocurriendo porque nos hemos olvidado de nuestro Dios.
But God says each year,
pero Dios dice cada año,
if you pay careful attention,
si prestas atención,
I'll take care of the problem.
Yo me encargo del problema.
Because I'm the strongest.
Porque yo soy el más fuerte.
I'm the best.
Yo soy el mejor.
And I'll send them away.
Y yo los echo fuera.
Because I'm the light.
Porque yo soy la luz.
And what happens when you turn on the light?
¿Y qué sucede cuando enciendes la luz?
Where do the cockroaches go?
¿Para dónde se van las cucarachas?
Same.
In the little corners.
And that's why you wear the pointy shoes.
Yeah, that's why you wear the roach killers.
Mm-hmm. But they scatter.
But they, ellos se dispersan.
If we bring the light,
si traemos la luz,
God will scatter the cockroaches.
Dios va a dispersar las cucarachas.
Because they're not a strong army.
Porque no son una milicia
fuerte.
They're
a bunch of cowards.
Son un grupo de cobardes.
But unless the Lord guards the house,
pero a menos que Dios vele la casa,
the watchmen watch in vain.
En vano velan lo que.
So Shavuot, Shavuot is about remembering that covenant.
Shavuot se trata de acordarnos de ese pacto.
Remembering that we are His treasure.
Acordándonos que nosotros somos su tesoro.
And that we should be married to our beloved in heaven.
Y que debemos estar casados a nuestro amado en el cielo.
And that's why when Yeshua said to the emissaries,
y por eso que cuando Yeshua le dijo a los emisarios,
stay here.
Manténganse aquí.
Don't leave Jerusalem.
No te vayas de Jerusalén.
Wait for what the Father has promised.
Espera por lo que el Padre ha prometido.
These guys already understood.
Estos ya entendieron.
Because they walked with the word for a couple of years.
Porque ellos caminaron con la palabra por un par de años.
It is we that don't understand.
Somos nosotros que no entendemos.
It is all those people, those idiots at the institute that you went to.
Son todos esos idiotas en el instituto.
Teaching complete heresy.
Enseñando heresía.
And charging money for it. And charging a lot of money for it.
Y cobrando mucho dinero por eso.
And they don't know their butt from their head.
Y ellos no conocen su trasero de su cabeza.
Okay? It's so simple if you love God.
Es tan simple si amas a Dios.
If you love His word,
si amas su palabra,
it is not hard.
No es difícil.
How can people stay married for 50, 60, 70 years?
¿Cómo pueden las personas estar casados por 50, 70 años?
Because they love one another.
Porque ellos se aman el uno al otro.
They're friends with one another.
Son amigos con uno el otro.
They understand the vow that they made.
Ellos entienden el voto que ellos hicieron.
That's what most people do not understand.
Eso es lo que la mayoría no entienden.
So when Yeshua said to the emissaries,
so cuando Yeshua le dijo a los emisarios,
stay here.
Manténganse aquí.
Wait here for what the Father has promised.
Esperen aquí por lo que ha prometido el Padre.
They understood completely
Ellos entendieron completamente.
You got to pass off the mic. You got to tap out there, son.
I got to tap out.
Veronica, could you tap in here for a second? This is what high sugars. Potato chips will catch you all the time. Got it? So they understood it is we that don't understand.
Entonces ellos entendieron que somos nosotros los que no entendemos.
And that's my job.
Y ese es mi trabajo.
To try to teach you.
Para tratar de enseñarte.
So that you can teach your children.
Así tú puedes enseñar a tus hijos.
But most of all.
Pero más que todo.
We're all going to stand in that court.
Siempre, todos vamos a estar parados en esa corte.
And the books are going to be open.
Y los libros serán abiertos.
And then the book of life.
Y después el libro de la vida.
The books are going to testify for you or against you.
Los libros van a testificar por ti o en contra tuya.
Going on to the next slide.
Próxima página.
Verse 7 and 8 now.
Versos 7 y 8.
Moisés came, summoned the leaders of the people, and presented them with all these words which Jehovah had ordered him to say. All the people answered as one. Everything Jehovah has said, we will do. Moshe reported the words of the people to Jehovah. Okay? The key here,
la clave aquí,
is Shavuot is about leadership.
Es que Shavuot se trata de liderazgo.
Shavuot is about leadership.
Shavuot se trata de liderazgo.
Because God is summoning his leaders.
Porque Dios está reuniendo a sus líderes.
He's summoning you, Frank, to a higher calling.
Él te está llamando a ti a una llamado más alto.
He's summoning you, Jorge, to a higher calling.
Te está llamando para una algo más alto, un llamado más alto.
And each year he wants to remind us about it.
Y cada año quiere recordarnos acerca de él.
Remind you of what your leadership position is.
Recordarte de qué tu posición de liderazgo se trata.
Because why?
¿Por qué?
What did we read before this?
¿Qué leímos antes de esto?
You're supposed to be a nation of priests.
Se supone que debemos ser una nación de sacerdotes.
A priest is a leader.
Un
Kohanim is a leader.
El Kohanim es un líder, un sacerdote.
You are the intercessors before the Lord.
Ustedes son los intercesores ante el Señor.
You're the ones that are leading Yeshua's sheep.
Ustedes son los que están guiando a los borregos de Yeshua.
You're the one who's taking care of his sheep.
Ustedes son los que están cuidando de sus ovejas.
What did Yeshua say to Kepha?
¿Qué es lo que Yeshua le dijo a Kepha?
Feed my lambs.
Alimenta a mis corderos.
What should you feed them?
¿Y con qué se les debe alimentar?
Chocolate.
Con chocolate.
Pizza.
Con pizza.
Croissants.
Oh, sauce. Sauce?
Croissant is a French word, so it's croissant.
Oh, croissants. Croissant. O los cachitos.
It's a type of bread.
Es un tipo de pan.
I didn't get to that yet. I'm getting there. Got to build, Mariel. Summon the leaders.
Llamar a los líderes.
Means that we're all supposed to be there.
Significa que todos debemos estar ahí.
Then in verse 8, as Adriana was pointing out,
el verso 8 que Adriana estaba señalando,
the people answer.
La gente respondió.
Everything Jehovah says,
todo lo que Jehovah ha dicho,
we will do.
Haremos.
This is a sadness about most of the body.
Esa es la tristeza acerca de la mayoría del cuerpo.
And why Islam is being raised up.
Y por qué el Islam está siendo levantado.
Because we don't agree with God.
Porque no estamos de acuerdo con Dios.
Most of the body, well, all the Gentile body,
la mayoría del cuerpo, del cuerpo gentil,
says we don't have to follow the law.
Dice que no tenemos que seguir la ley.
Then verse 8 is gone for you.
I'm sorry?
Verse 8 is gone for you.
Oh, el verso 8 ya no existe para ti.
But it was there for Israel for a little bit.
Pero estuvo ahí para Israel por un tiempo.
The other part about Shavuot,
la otra parte acerca de Shavuot,
is remembering,
es recordar,
how we failed.
¿Cómo es que fallamos?
How we made God angry.
¿Cómo es que enojamos a Dios?
How we didn't trust in him.
¿Cómo es que no confiamos en él?
And it cost us 40 years in the desert.
Y nos costó 40 años en el desierto.
You know, a two-week trip costs 40 years.
Un viaje de dos semanas nos costó 40 años.
Why?
¿Por qué?
Because we didn't have GPS.
Porque no tuvimos el GPS.
God's positioning system.
El sistema de posición de Dios.
We didn't want to follow the direction.
No quisimos seguir sus direcciones.
Before GPS,
antes del GPS,
there was MapQuest.
Había los mapas.
Where you printed out the directions.
Donde tú imprimías las direcciones.
And God has printed out his directions.
Y Dios ha imprimido su dirección.
And that's why he gives us the Bible.
Por eso es que nos da la Biblia.
Okay. Now, why does it say summoning the leaders?
¿Por qué no dice llamar a los líderes?
And what's important to that?
¿Y qué es importante acerca de eso?
Turn to Acts chapter 1, hold your place.
Mantengan su lugar y vámonos a Hechos.
Acts 1, verse 12 and 13.
Hechos 1, versos 12 y 13.
Come on, B. Come on, I got the CD. Oh, you got it on the phone. There's no page numbers on the phone. Acts chapter 1, verse 12 and 13.
Hechos capítulo 1, versos 12 y 13.
Dun, 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 dun. When you got it, everybody got it? Okay. Then they returned the Shabbat walk distance from the Mount of Olives to Jerusalem. After entering the city, they went to the upstairs room where they were staying. The names of the emissaries were Kepha, Yaakov, Yochanan, Andrew, Philip, Thomas, Barthomai, Matthiahu, Yaakov ben Helfai, Shimon the Zealot, and Yehuda ben Yaakov. Why do we have those names in verse 13?
¿Por qué tenemos en el verso 13 esos nombres?
What would you classify those people as?
¿Cómo es que se clasificaban a estas personas?
The leaders.
Como líderes.
That's why it's there.
Por eso es que están allí.
Because Yeshua summoned them back.
Porque Yeshua los llamó otra vez.
That's why it's there.
Por eso es que está allí.
Because Exodus 19, verse 7 was there.
Porque Éxodos 19, verso 7 estuvo allí.
Summoning the leaders.
Llamar a los líderes.
Do you want to pass the mic back?
No, whatever.
Well, you did a message. He usually does Bible study.
I don't care.
Well, you should learn for a little bit. Well, what would you classify Matthew? The disciple Matthew. You would classify him as a leader.
Clasificarías como un líder.
Okay. So this is why verse 13 is there.
So esto es porque el versículo 13 está ahí.
Is because it has to fulfill what we see in the Torah.
Es porque tiene que cumplir con lo que está en el Torah.
Going to the next slide.
Ahora en la próxima página.
Let's go back to Exodus 19.
Regresemos a Éxodo capítulo 19.
Verse 9, please.
Versículo 9. Three swipes.
Now, if you do it fast, is it one swipe?
Yeah, if I do it fast, it goes to the end of the chapter, though.
Oh, wait. Verse 9.
Versículo 9.
Jehovah said to Moshe, "See, I'm coming to you in a thick cloud, so that the people will be able to hear when I speak with you. And also to trust in you forever." Moshe had told Jehovah what the people had said. Okay, so the key words here in this verse.
Las palabras claves aquí en este versículo.
Coming to you.
Viniendo a ti.
Thick cloud.
Nube espesa.
People will be able to hear.
Las personas podrán escuchar.
Okay, so. The key one we're going to start with is people able to hear.
La palabra clave con que vamos a comenzar es la gente podrán escuchar.
This is why everybody focuses on that.
Por eso es que todos se enfocan en eso.
In Acts.
En Hechos.
In Acts chapter 2.
En Hechos capítulo 2.
We can hear them.
Lo podemos escuchar.
They were speaking in tongues.
Estaban hablando en lenguas.
Well, the key here is that God said,
la clave aquí es que Dios dijo,
I'm going to come to you.
Voy a venir a ti.
And you're going to be able to hear me.
Y vas a poder escucharme.
Okay? Coming to you,
viniendo a ti,
ties together what Yeshua is saying.
Se enlaza con lo que Yeshua dijo.
Stay here in Jerusalem.
Mantente aquí en Jerusalén.
God will come to you.
Dios vendrá a ti.
Stay here.
Quédate aquí.
Camp at the mountain.
Quédate en la montaña.
Now, where were the disciples?
¿A dónde están los discípulos?
In Jerusalem, right?
En Jerusalén, ¿no? En Jerusalén.
They're on a mountain.
Están en la montaña.
Jerusalem's on a mountain.
Jerusalén está en la monta en una montaña.
It's on the plateau of a mountain.
Está en el plato de una montaña.
See? Yes.
Like, it's interesting because when you speak to the Lord and that he hears you, what did Moshe have to go tell the Lord? What did they say?
Because he didn't. He didn't listen.
No.
With the Levitical priesthood.
Con el sacerdocio levítico.
You didn't have a direct line to God.
Tú no tenías una línea directa con Dios.
There was an intercessor.
Había un intercesor.
That's why when I pray,
por eso que
I pray to Yeshua.
Yo le oro a Yeshua.
Because he's the intercessor.
Porque él es el intercesor.
You don't get to daddy.
Tú no puedes llegar a papá.
Except through the son.
Sino a través de
Yeshua. That's God's order.
Eso es la orden de Dios.
Nobody gets to dad except through me, says Yeshua.
Nadie llega al padre sino por mí, dice Yeshua.
That's why I tend to send my prayers to him.
Por eso que yo le envío mis oraciones.
Welcome to Beth Goyim.
Bienvenido a Beth Goyim.
That's why you say the other day to somebody that they ask that that's why you go with Yeshua.
He's our intercessor, says Hebrews.
En el libro de Hebreos dice que él es nuestro intercesor.
Yeah, I think it's kind of disrespectful to bypass him.
Yo creo que es una falta de respeto sobrepasarlo.
You know, he gave his life for me.
Si él entregó su vida para mí.
But the disciples understood this.
Pero los discípulos entendieron esto.
They understood that God was going to be coming to them.
Ellos entendieron que Dios iba a venir hacia ellos.
That's why it says the giving of Torah.
Por eso que dice en la entrega de Torah.
Not the receiving of Torah.
No el recibimiento de Torah.
He gives.
Él da.
He comes.
Él viene.
So that's why in verse 9,
por eso que en versículo
this
9,
phrase coming to you is vitally important.
Esta frase llegando a ti es sumamente importante.
Okay, then the next part,
y la segunda parte,
in a thick cloud.
En una nube espesa.
The thick cloud meaning you don't want to see the glory of God.
La nube espesa es que no puedes ver, you cannot. No puedes ver la gloria de Dios.
You cannot see the kavod of God.
No puedes ver el kavod de Dios.
Okay, so the cloud would mask that glory.
La nube tapaba esa gloria.
But the cloud also amplifies the sound.
Pero la nube también amplifica el sonido.
So that's why he says in the middle of verse 9.
Por eso que dice en el medio del versículo 9.
People will be able to hear when I speak.
La gente van a poder escuchar cuando yo hablo.
Because the cloud will amplify the sound.
Porque la nube va a amplificar el sonido.
Okay? Because it's going to bounce off the cloud into your head.
Porque va a rebotar de la nube a tu cabeza.
Okay? Now, hold your place there.
Mantén tu lugar ahí.
Let's go to Acts chapter 2, verse 3.
Vamos a Hechos capítulo 2, versículo 3.
Anybody learning something here?
¿Están aprendiendo algo aquí?
Yes. It was a place in Jerusalem. They were not in the temple.
The afternoon probably will have also like some
Era un el aposento alto era un lugar en Jerusalén, no era en el templo.
Acts chapter 2 verse 3.
Hechos capítulo 2 versículo 3.
Then they saw what looked like tongues of fire which separated and came to rest on each one of them. Okay? Has anybody ever seen fire burn without smoke?
La gente han visto el fuego quemar sin humo.
Would fire then make a cloud?
El fuego haría una nube.
Would fire make a cloud?
El fuego haría una nube.
When there's smoke, there's fire.
Donde hay humo, hay fuego.
Why does it say there's fire?
¿Por qué dice que hay fuego?
Because God said, I'm coming to you in a thick cloud.
Porque Dios dijo que vengo hacia ti en una nube.
This ties into what Adriana just said.
Esto se enlaza con lo que dijo Adriana.
Where they're in an upper room.
Porque ellos estaban en un aposento alto.
So if the tongues of fire came in,
si las lenguas de fuego
fire is going to bring smoke.
El humo va a traer el fuego va a traer humo.
God's going to come in a thick cloud.
Dios va a venir en en una nube densa, gruesa.
Okay.
I was just thinking about Turkabasti.
Let's go to the next slide.
Ahora vamos a la próxima página.
Turn to Acts chapter 1 verse 11.
Vamos a Hechos capítulo 1 versículo 11.
The men said, "You Galileans, why are you standing, staring into space? This Yeshua who had been taken away from you into heaven will come back to you just the same way as you saw him go up into heaven." What's in heaven?
¿Qué es lo que hay en el cielo?
Like when you look up in the sky, what do you see a lot of times?
Cuando ves en el cielo, ¿qué ves muchas veces?
Clouds.
Nubes.
Why were the disciples looking up?
¿Por qué los discípulos están mirando hacia
God
arriba?
Is pointing it to the clouds.
Dios está señalando,
and they're looking for him to come back.
Y están mirando para su regreso.
Why are they looking for him to come back?
Porque están mirando que regrese.
Because God said, I'm going to send the promise.
Porque Dios dijo que voy a enviar la promesa.
And that goes back to Exodus 19, verse 9.
Y eso regresa a Éxodo capítulo 19, versículo 9.
Going on to the next slide.
Ahora vamos a la próxima página.
Let's now go back to Exodus 19.
Regresemos a Éxodo capítulo 19.
Verse 10 and 11.
Versículo 10 y el 11.
So Jehovah said to Moshe, "Go to the people today and tomorrow. Separate them from me by having them wash their clothing and prepare for the third day. For the third day Jehovah will come down on Mount Sinai before the eyes of all the people." So here we're going to focus on two things.
So aquí nos vamos a enfocar en dos cosas.
Separation.
Separación.
And washing your clothes.
Y lavando su ropa.
Okay. What? Separation.
Separación.
Is choosing to walk with God.
Es escogiendo caminar con Dios.
Choosing to be with Him.
Escogiendo estar con Él.
Allowing your life to be separated.
Permitiendo que tu vida sea separado.
Okay. Separation.
Separación.
Means that it goes back to becoming a nation of priests.
Regresa hacerse una nación de sacerdotes.
The next part about separation,
la próxima parte de separación,
is washing their clothes.
Es lavando tu ropa.
You got to change and put on the things of God.
Tienes que cambiarte y ponerte las cosas de Dios.
You got to take off those dirty, profaned clothing.
Tienes que quitarte esa ropa profanada.
And you got to start dressing like a royal priesthood.
Y tienes que empezar a vestirte como un sacerdocio real.
Because the royal priesthood is a very plain looking grouping of people.
Porque el sacerdocio real es un grupo de personas que se ven simple.
It's a uniform that they're supposed to wear.
Es un uniforme que están supuestos usar.
Do you wear God's uniform?
Tú usas el uniforme de Dios.
Now hold your place in Exodus 19.
Ahora mantén tu lugar ahí en Éxodo capítulo 19.
Salud. Turn to Matthew 25.
Vamos a Mateo capítulo 25.
Matthew 25.
Mateo 25.
Verse 32, please.
Versículo 32.
Sí. We're going to get there. Matthew 25, verse 32.
Mateo capítulo 25, versículo 32.
Matthew 25, verse 32.
Mateo capítulo 25, versículo 32.
Everybody got it?
Todos lo tienen.
All the nations will be assembled before him, and he will separate people one from another as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats.
Amen.
Okay? All the nations.
Todas las naciones.
Oh, that's talking about Shavuot.
Eso está hablando de Shavuot.
All the nations were gathered before the Lord to receive the Torah.
Todas las naciones estaban reunidas ante el Señor para recibir la Torah.
And then in verse 32,
y en versículo 32,
in the middle of the verse,
en el centro del versículo,
the Lord is going to separate people.
El Señor va a separar la gente.
Verse 10 of chapter 19,
versículo 10 del capítulo 19,
the Lord said, before we receive the Torah,
Dios dice, antes que recibamos la Torah,
before we receive that marriage contract,
antes de que reciban ese contrato matrimonial,
we had to separate ourselves.
Teníamos que habernos separado.
We had to separate from the pagans.
Nos teníamos que separar de los paganos.
We got to separate the way we think.
Tenemos que separar la manera que pensamos.
We had to be obedient to what he was asking.
Teníamos que ser obediente a lo que él estaba pidiendo.
How is the Lord going to separate the people?
¿Cómo el Señor va a separar a las personas?
Now say the Lord looks at a Christian.
Vamos a decir que el Señor mira a un cristiano.
And a Muslim.
Y un musulmán.
Who's going to be closer to the Lord? The Muslim or the Christian?
¿Quién va a estar más cerca al Señor, un musulmán o el cristiano?
No, if you had to like put the points on the board.
Si tú tenías que poner puntuajes en la pizarra.
The Christian, you think?
¿El cristiano tú piensas?
Or the Muslim?
¿O el musulmán?
If you're weighing them out.
Si lo estás midiendo. None of the two.
Who says the Muslim?
¿Quién dice el musulmán?
Who says the Christian? Why do you say the Christian?
Why do I say the Christian? Well, yeah, he said, you said to pick one. That's well, the Christian, because the Christian believes in the word, so to say, although they don't practice it, but neither does the Muslim. The Muslim practices a whole lie. The only thing he has in common with us is he's circumcised and he keeps kosher.
2 points.
That's it.
How many points did the Christian get? 2 points for the Muslims. Let's translate. The Muslim keeps kosher.
El musulmán mantiene kosher.
The Muslim circumcises his son.
El musulmán circuncida a su hijo.
You're supposed to.
No, they all do. All the Muslims are circumcised.
The Muslim, the mu-
oh. Oh, no, I'm talking about The Muslim, el musulmán.
Won't touch a pig.
No va a tocar un cerdo.
But
they should.
No, they're not supposed to.
But they do.
So are Jews.
Well, también los judíos.
I'm just saying what the book says.
Solamente estoy diciendo lo que dice el libro.
I want you to see something.
Quiero que vean algo.
3 points for the Muslim.
3 puntos para el
Does the Christian circumcise?
No.
Does the Christian keep kosher?
No.
Does the Christian touch pig?
Yes.
So who's closer?
So quién es más cerca, el musulmán?
Satan knows the word.
Satanás conoce la palabra.
Satan doesn't want to follow the word.
Satanás no quiere seguir la palabra.
Nor does the Muslim.
Tampoco el musulmán.
Isn't that sad to say?
No es triste decir.
You can say all you want.
Puede decir todo lo que quiera.
Donald Trump says he's going to win.
Trump dice que va a ganar.
We all know that the Lord is going to raise up Teddy Cruz.
Todos nosotros sabemos que el Señor va a levantar a Ted Cruz.
A man of honor and dignity.
Un hombre de honor y dignidad.
If we get there, which I don't think
si
we
llegamos
do.
Ahí.
He'll be the president of the South.
Va a ser el presidente del sur.
Matthew 25, verse 32.
Mateo capítulo 25, versículo 32.
Yeshua talks about separating the people.
Yeshua habla de separar la gente.
Shavuot is about separation.
Shavuot se trata de separación.
Stepping in God's footsteps.
Pisando en las huellas de Dios.
Because how did we get to the mountain?
Porque cómo es que llegamos a la montaña?
We followed God.
Seguimos a Dios.
He led us.
Él nos guió.
He said, "Follow me."
Él dijo, "Síganme."
So here Yeshua is pointing us to Shavuot.
So aquí Yeshua nos está señalando a Shavuot.
Separate.
Separar.
The sheep from the goat.
Las ovejas de los cabros.
Those that are my beloved.
Aquellos que son mis amados.
And those that are not.
Y aquellos que no son.
Let's go to the next slide.
Vamos a la próxima página.
Let's go back to Shemot, Exodus 19.
Vamos de nuevo a Éxodo capítulo 19.
Can we go for another 15 minutes so we can finish this part?
Podemos ir, 15 minutos más.
15 minutes?
15 minutos para terminar esta parte.
Okay, verse 12 and 13. Exodus 19, verse 12 and 13.
Éxodo capítulo 19, versículos 12 y 13.
You are to set limits for the people all around and say, "Be careful not to go up on the mountain or even touch its base. Whoever touches the mountain will surely be put to death. No hand is to touch him, for he must be stoned or shot by arrows. Neither animal nor human will be allowed to live. When the shofar sounds, they may go up onto the mountain." On the mountain. Okay? Verse 12,
versículo 12
is very important, the beginning part.
Es la parte primera es bien importante.
You are to set limits for the people all around.
Tienes que poner límites para la gente que están alrededor.
When Yeshua told them to wait,
cuando Yeshua le dijo que esperen,
his disciples to wait there,
sus discípulos que esperen ahí,
why did he tell them to do that?
Porque él les dijo que hicieran eso.
He was setting limits.
Él estaba poniendo límites.
Don't leave here.
No te vayas de aquí.
Don't leave where you are.
No te vayas de donde estén.
And this is what we don't follow.
Y esto es lo que nosotros no seguimos.
He was setting a limit. Don't. I will send, wait here for what the Father has promised.
Espere aquí por lo que ha prometido el Padre.
You've already seen his death.
Ya ha visto su muerte.
His resurrection.
Su resurrección.
You've hung out with him now for 40 days after his death.
Ha pasado 40 días con él después de su muerte.
And he tells you to wait here?
Y si él te dice que espere aquí?
I ain't moving.
Yo no me voy a mover.
Maybe go to the bathroom, but that's about it.
Tal vez ir al baño, pero eso es
todo. I'm not going anywhere else.
Yo no voy para ningún otro lado.
So here, in verse 12,
so aquí en el versículo 12,
set limits for the people.
Pon límites para las personas.
Then the next half of the sentence.
Y la segunda parte de la oración.
Be careful.
Ten cuidado.
Shavuot is about learning how to be careful.
Shavuot se trata de cómo ser cuidadoso.
Because it's the giving of Torah.
Porque es la entrega de Torah.
It teaches us how to be careful.
Nos enseña cómo ser cuidadosos.
Okay. Then in verse 13.
Y entonces en el versículo 13.
It says if somebody is not careful.
Si alguien no tiene cuidado.
Stone them to death.
Apedréalo hasta la muerte.
Or shoot them with arrows.
O dispárele flechas.
Why is he so strong about that?
¿Por qué él es tan fuerte sobre esto?
Remember the Garden of Eden.
Acuérdate el jardín de Edén.
The Garden of Eden. God told us, "Don't touch that."
Dios nos dijo, "No toques eso."
Now he's about to give us his marriage contract.
Y ahora él está presto para entregar el contrato de matrimonio.
How many marriages fail before they even get started?
¿Cuántos matrimonios se fracasan?
Many.
Antes de que comiencen.
Because of the bachelor party.
Muchos por la fiesta de solteros.
Because there's usually always one of these at the bachelor party.
Porque siempre hay uno de esos de las fiestas de
solteros. And those secular bachelor parties are very pagan.
Y las fiestas de solteros seculares son bien paganas.
And men do stupid things at these parties.
Y los hombres hacen cosas bien estúpidas.
So God is saying here,
so Dios está diciendo aquí,
before we get married,
antes de que nos casemos,
separate yourself,
sepárate,
wash your clothes,
limpia, lava tu ropa,
and if somebody doesn't listen, shoot them.
Y si alguien no hace caso, dispárenle.
Say again? No, this is for all the people.
Estas instrucciones eran para todas las personas, no solamente los líderes.
And yes, I agree with you, Evelyn. Muslims kill for their own needs and rape their women. But I was asking who is closer to the Lord, a Christian or a Muslim? And points are points.
Yep. Puntos son puntos.
Setting limits.
Poniendo límites.
Don't touch something.
No toques algo.
What did God say about the fruit?
¿Qué Dios dijo sobre la fruta?
Don't touch it.
No lo toques.
Don't touch it.
No lo toques.
And you keep my covenant.
Y tú guardas mi pacto.
And he's saying it once again.
Y él está diciendo nuevamente.
Why is he saying it?
Porque él está diciendo.
Because he was about to give us something beautiful.
Porque estaba presto a entregarnos algo bello.
And he didn't want somebody there,
y no quería alguien ahí,
who couldn't follow simple commandments.
Que no podía seguir mandamientos simples.
It's the same with going to heaven.
Es igual con subir al cielo.
Then finally in verse 13,
y finalmente en el versículo 13,
it talks about the shofar.
Habla sobre el shofar.
Where does the shofar come from?
¿De dónde viene el shofar?
The horn of the ram.
El cuerno del cordero.
Why the horn of the ram, Ariadna?
¿Por qué el cuerno del cordero?
Huh? Was a, yes. But what particular, for who? Who?
Adán y Eva.
No.
Isaac.
Yitzhak. Okay. The son of obedience,
el hijo de obediencia,
gets the promises of God.
Recibe las promesas de Dios.
Let me say that again.
Deja repetir eso.
The son of obedience,
el hijo de obediencia,
gets the inheritance of God.
Recibe la herencia de Dios.
Yeshua said to the Talmudim,
Yeshua dijo a los discípulos,
stay here.
Mantente aquí.
Wait for the promise.
Espera la promesa.
They knew what he was talking about.
Ellos sabían de lo que él hablaba.
Because they had walked with the word for a couple of years.
Porque ellos caminaron con la palabra un par de años.
Next slide.
La próxima página.
Verse 14 and 15.
Versículos 14 y 15.
Pay attention now to this one.
Atención. Presten atención.
Moshe went down from the mountain to the people and separated the people for Elohim. And they washed their clothing. He said to the people, prepare for the third day. Don't approach a woman. Okay? The key for this particular two verses,
la clave aquí para estos dos versículos en particular,
is about washing.
Es sobre lavar.
But it doesn't say wash yourselves, it says wash your clothing.
No dice que te laves a ti, dice que te laves tu ropa.
Okay? Washing your clothing,
lava tu ropa,
is cleaning the dirt in the world off of you.
Es limpiando el sucio del mundo de ti.
Why is this important to understand about Shavuot?
¿Por qué es importante entender esto sobre Shavuot?
Hold your place there.
Mantén tu lugar ahí.
Go to Revelation 22, verse 14.
Vamos al Apocalipsis capítulo 22, versículo 14.
Revelation 22, 14.
Apocalipsis 22, 14.
Welcome to Beth Goyim.
Bienvenido a Beth Goyim.
Bienvenido.
Bienvenido.
Bienvenido. Revelation 22:14.
Apocalipsis capítulo 22, versículo 14.
Got it? Okay. Got it, Margarita? 14. How blessed are those who wash their robes so they have the right to eat from the tree of life and go through the gates into the city. Blessed if you wash your clothing.
Bendito si lavas tu ropa.
If you follow in obedience,
si sigues en obediencia,
then you have the right to go touch that tree.
Entonces tienes el derecho a tocar ese árbol.
Because you held on to the covenant.
Porque has mantenido el pacto.
And that's what Shavuot is all about.
Y de eso lo que se trata, Shavuot.
It's about remembering all this.
Se trata de acordarse uno de todo esto.
That's why the holy days are so important.
Por eso que los días santos son tan importantes.
And why it's so sad that most don't do this.
Y es tan triste que la mayoría no hacen esto.
And even sadly, many messianic congregations.
Y tristemente muchas congregaciones mesiánicas.
You get this white robe.
Tú recibes esta bata blanca.
When you reach the goal.
Cuando llegas a la meta.
You walked. You ran the race.
Corriste la carrera.
And then you have the right to eat.
Y entonces tienes el derecho de comer.
Would not your husband in heaven, God,
no será que tu esposo en el cielo, Dios,
provide for his beloved?
Provee por su amada.
The other part, going back to Exodus 19, please, verse 15.
La otra parte, regresando a Éxodo capítulo 19, versículo
19:15.
Capítulo 19, versículo 15.
He said to the people, prepare for the third day. Don't approach a woman. Why is that there?
¿Por qué está eso ahí?
Why is that there?
¿Por qué está eso ahí?
Because if you've had marital relations,
porque
you're
si
unclean.
Porque si ha tenido relaciones matrimoniales, va a estar impío. Impuro.
And if there's blood,
y si hay sangre,
you're unclean for longer.
Está impuro por más tiempo.
So God is wanting you to be at his day.
So Dios quiere que tú estés en su día.
Going on to the next part.
Ahora la próxima parte.
Next slide, please, verse 16.
La próxima página, por favor, versículo 16.
On the morning of the third day, there was thunder, lightning, and a thick cloud on the mountain. Then the shofar blast sounded so loudly that all the people in the camp trembled. Okay? So here we're going to key on third day.
Aquí las claves va a ser el tercer día.
Thunder.
Truenos.
Lightning in a thick cloud.
Relámpago en la nube densa.
Shofar blast.
Sonido de shofar.
That rattled the whole earth.
Que tembló toda la tierra.
Okay. So the third day.
El tercer día.
What happened on the third day?
¿Qué sucedió en el tercer día?
Life came.
La vida llegó.
And remember, in the Gospels,
y acuérdate que en los evangelios,
when Yeshua rose from the grave,
cuando Yeshua resucitó de la tumba,
and came out of the tomb,
salió de la tumba, en el tercer día.
It was the third day.
Era el tercer día.
And then the whole Roman those soldiers fell down like dead men.
Y esos soldados romanos cayeron como muertos.
The cloud was once again there in verse 16.
La nube estaba ahí nuevamente en el versículo 16.
That kavod of the Lord.
El kavod del Señor.
Okay. Then the shofar so loud that the earth trembled.
Y después el shofar sonó tan fuerte que tembló la tierra.
The sound of God's voice breaks the cedars, it says in Psalm.
El sonido de la voz de Dios rompe los cedros, dice en los salmos.
Hold your place.
Mantén tu lugar.
Turn to Acts chapter 2, verse 2.
Vamos a Hechos capítulo 2, versículo 2.
Acts chapter 2.
Hechos capítulo 2. I got it already.
Kavod, the glory.
Kavod es gloria.
Acts chapter 2, verse 2.
Hechos capítulo 2, versículo 2. Cabot, Gloria.
Acts chapter 2.
Hechos capítulo 2.
Verse 2.
Versículo 2.
Suddenly there came a sound from the sky like the roar of a violent wind. It filled the whole house where they were sitting. Sounds just like what we read in Exodus.
Suena igual que lo que leímos en Éxodo.
Why was it roar of a violent wind?
Porque era el rugir de un viento violento.
What would happen if you sound the shofar so loud it shook the ground?
¿Qué sucedería si tú suenas un shofar tan fuerte que tiembla la tierra?
It's so loud that the whole camp of 600,000 men trembled.
Fue tan fuerte que el campamento de 600,000 personas, hombres, temblaron.
Would that be a violent sound?
¿Será eso un sonido violento?
Oh, that's why it's saying that in Acts chapter 2.
Por eso que lo dice en Hechos capítulo 2.
This violent wind blowing through where the disciples were.
Este viento violento soplando a donde estaban los discípulos.
And it filled the whole house where they were sitting. Why?
Y llenó la casa entera donde estaban sentados. ¿Por qué?
Because in Exodus 19, verse 16,
porque en Éxodo capítulo 19, versículo 16,
it said that the sound was so loud that the people, the whole camp trembled.
Dice que el sonido fue tan fuerte que las personas del campamento temblaron.
Next slide.
La próxima página.
Verse 17 and 18, going back to Exodus.
Regresando a Éxodo, capítulo 19, versículos 17 y 18.
Verse 17 and 18.
Versículos 17 y el 18.
Moshe brought the people out of the camp to meet Elohim. They stood near the base of the mountain. Mount Sinai was enveloped in smoke because Jehovah descended onto it in fire. Its smoke went up like the smoke from a furnace, and the whole mountain shook violently. That's why we just read the Acts scripture.
Por eso que terminamos de leer la escritura del libro de los Hechos.
A violent wind came.
Un viento violento llegó.
And then we look at to meet God.
Para encontrarse con Dios.
What did Yeshua say?
¿Qué dijo Yeshua?
Wait here.
Esperen aquí.
I'm going to send.
Voy a enviar.
Wait for God's promise.
Espera por la promesa de Dios.
Then Mount Sinai was enveloped in smoke.
Y entonces Mount Sinai estaba rodeado de humo.
Didn't it say tongues of fire?
¿No dijo lenguas de fuego?
What comes with fire?
¿Qué viene con fuego?
Smoke.
Humo.
Okay, why?
¿Por qué?
Why did it say tongues of fire?
¿Por qué dijo lenguas de fuego?
Because the whole mountain was filled with smoke.
Porque la montaña entera estaba llena de humo.
Now, smoke from a furnace.
Ahora humo de un horno.
Hold your place there.
Aguante, mantén tu lugar ahí.
Turn to Revelation 15, verse 8.
Vamos a Apocalipsis, capítulo 15, versículo 8.
Revelation 15.
Apocalipsis, capítulo 15.
Hold your place. In Exodus.
Mantén tu lugar en Éxodo.
Verse 8.
Versículo 8.
Got it?
The last verse.
Then the sanctuary was filled with smoke from God's Shekinah, that is, from his power. And no one could enter the sanctuary until the seven plagues of the seven angels had accomplished their purpose. So the smoke is God's Shekinah.
So el humo es el Shekinah de Dios.
So when God's smoke filled the whole mountain,
so cuando el humo de Dios llenó la montaña entera,
it was his glory.
Era su gloria.
And we see that from Revelation 15, verse 8.
So, vemos eso de Apocalipsis, capítulo 15, versículo 8. What, there was another time, though, that they were ministering to the Lord, and the temple was filled with so much smoke that they couldn't minister anymore.
I think you're mixing up a couple of things. I know the Isaiah scripture.
I forgot where I read that at. It, They were in the temple and they were singing to the Lord and blowing the shofar, and all of a sudden the cloud came down into the temple and filled up the temple, and it was so full with smoke that they couldn't continue administering to the Lord. It's I forgot where I read that at.
It's possible. I'm drawing a blank from what you're saying to me. I mean, the Isaiah scripture.
Huh?
The train of the robe, his robe filled the sanctuary.
Is that it? No.
I'm not sure what's in your head.
Yeah.
Going back to the study, going to the next slide.
Regresando a la próxima página.
I got a couple more verses to do, sorry.
Un par de versículos más para hacer.
Two more minutes.
Dos minutos más.
Verse 19, Exodus 19, verse 19.
Exodus, capítulo 19, versículo 19.
This is your key verse for tongue people.
Este es tu verso clave para las personas de lengua.
As the sound of the shofar grew louder and louder, Moshe spoke and God answered him with a voice. Okay? So here you see God speaking on Shavuot.
So aquí ves que Dios está hablando en Shavuot.
He speaks to who?
Él está hablando a quién?
All the people.
Todas las personas.
On Shavuot.
En Shavuot.
Because who was in the crowd?
Porque quién estaba en la multitud.
A mixed multitude.
Una multitud mixta.
Now hold your place.
Ahora mantén tu lugar.
Acts 2, verse 6 and 7.
Hechos capítulo 2, versículos 6 y 7.
Acts 2, verse 6 and 7.
Hechos capítulo 2, versículos 6 y 7.
When they heard the sound, the crowd gathered. They were confused because each one heard the believers speaking in his own language. Totally amazed, they asked, how is this possible? Aren't all these people speaking from the Galal? Who was speaking in Acts?
¿Quién estaba hablando en
it was God who was speaking through his people.
Era Dios que estaba hablando a través de su pueblo, su gente.
Because when does God speak?
Porque cuando es que Dios habla.
What day was it?
Es Shavuot.
What does Acts chapter 2 verse 1 say?
Que Hechos capítulo 2 versículo 1
dice. It was Shavuot.
Era Shavuot.
He's speaking. Didn't God make everybody?
Dios no hizo a todos.
He's speaking to everybody.
So él estaba hablando a todos.
And those are the covenant.
En sus propias lenguas para que pudieran entender.
Who was he speaking to?
Y a quién él estaba hablando.
All that had come.
Todos los que han venido.
From all the nations.
De todas las naciones.
We're going to get to that next week.
Vamos a llegar a eso la semana que viene. Found a scripture.
Okay, Isaiah.
Second Chronicles 5:13 and 14.
Oh, Second Chronicles what?
5:13 and 14.
Right before, wait, with the dedication of the temple.
Yeah.
Hanukkah.
But it says that the cloud, the temple of the Lord was filled with the cloud, and then it says that the priest could not perform their service because of the cloud, for the glory of the Lord filled the temple.
Right, it was the dedication of the first temple. Because if you go to 7.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now let's go to the last slide.
Vamos a la última página.
Verse 20 through 25, Exodus 19.
Éxodo capítulo 19, versículos 20 al 25.
Jehovah came down unto Mount Sinai, the top of the mountain. Then Jehovah called to Moshe to the top of the mountain. Moshe went up. Jehovah said to Moshe, go down and warn the people not to force their way through to Jehovah to see him. If they do, many of them will perish. Even the Kohanim who are allowed to approach Jehovah must keep themselves holy, otherwise Jehovah may break out against them. Moshe said to Jehovah, the people can't come up to the mountain, Mount Sinai, because you ordered us to set limits around the mountain and separate it. But Jehovah answered, go get down, then come back up, you and Aaron with you. But don't let the Kohanim and the people force their way through to come up to Jehovah, or he will break out against them. So Moshe went down to the people and told them. key about these verses.
La clave sobre estos versículos.
Shavuot is about obedience.
Shavuot se trata de obediencia.
Then you will become a nation of priests.
Entonces serán una nación de sacerdotes.
On our next part next week,
en la próxima parte, la semana que viene,
we're going to see what God does in the next part of Shavuot.
Vamos a ver lo que Dios hace en la próxima parte de Shavuot.
And why this holy day is so vitally important.
Y por qué este día santo es sumamente importante.
We'll take questions in a moment.
Vamos a tomar preguntas en un
momento. Let's just close in prayer.
Vamos a cerrar en oración.
And we can take more questions.
Y podemos tomar más preguntas.
And if anybody's on online,
y si lo que están en línea,
on Skype, if you wish to stay on, you can stay on.
En Skype, si desean mantenerse conectados, pueden mantenerse conectados.
Thank you, Lord, for your blessings today. Thank you, Lord, for the study. Thank you, Lord, for this opportunity to share your word. Your name, Yeshua. Amen. Amen.
Shalom. This is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman. I would personally like to thank you for tuning in to the Remnant's Call each and every week. You can listen to the full message on our website, bethgoyim.org. If you have drawn closer to the King of Kings, learned more about Him today, we are blessed. If you are blessed by these messages, please consider a donation to our ministry. You can go to our website, bethgoyim.org. That's BETHGOYIM.org. And click on the donate button. You do not have to have a PayPal account to donate. All you need is a debit card. Once again, thank you very much for listening to The Remnant's Call.
If you have not taken your first steps to be born again, just ask God's help. Remember, it's His loving grace that has come to find you. No one is worthy or able to reach God, but God can reach us, and He's reaching out to you now. Just open your heart and let Him in. His arms are open, and the blessing of salvation and eternal life are waiting for you. Don't let it wait any longer.
Shalom. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord lift His face and shine upon you. May the Lord be gracious unto you and give you His shalom.
Shalom. My name is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman, and I invite you to come to visit our congregation. If you are in the tri-state area, come out and visit with us on Shabbat. We are a congregation of Jews and Gentiles living as one in the Messiah Yeshua. BGMC is a place of true worship. The focus never wanders from the Hebraic roots of our faith. Beth Goyim is rooted in the Word of God from Bereshit through to the Book of Revelation. Messiah's strong words against man-made tradition are carefully recorded in Matthew 7. That is the reason we only follow the straight-up instructions found in Scripture. Truly, the way, the truth, and the life. If you're looking for a deeper walk with Adonai, come out for our Tuesday evening Bible study called Messianic Torah Time. Come, spend the day with us on any Shabbat. We start at 11 a.m. with the sound of the ancient Hebrew shofar. Next, we offer our King praise and worship in English, Hebrew, and Spanish. After worship, we review the headlines in the previous week's news from around the globe, especially news from the Holy Land Israel. We don't just list the news headlines as current events, but we comb through the scriptures, searching for clues to understand what they mean, and then to help pinpoint prophetically our current position on Adonai's clock. After digesting all that modern information, we leave the world behind as we journey with our Adonai deep into His eternal word, not with just one or two scriptures, but usually seven or more scriptures. The spiritual nourishment and the richness of His kingdom become accessible to the ones who share this special time and seek them out. The day does not end there. Because Shabbat is so special to Him, there is always so much more that our King desires to share. So instead of separating and leaving, we stay together as a family for potluck lunch and an afternoon study of our King's Word. We close the Shabbat together with the reading of the new week's parashah. That's the Torah portion. Even after those blessings, many of us just can't get enough. So the members bring prepared homemade foods to share while we all enjoy an uplifting movie together. If all that information is not quite enough, you can check out our website where you will find over 200 video teachings and biblical holy day studies. Under Messianic Torah Time, the Hebrew Roots button, you'll discover free studies on many, many different topics, including PowerPoint slide presentations. If Beth Goyim sounds like a place you'd love to visit, but you live outside the tri-state area, there is still a way to connect with us. We stream live on the internet on Tuesday, Thursday, and Shabbat. The website is www.bethgoyim.org. That's BethGoyim.org. Our phone number is 973-338-7800 or 978-2-YESHUA. That's 978, the number 2, Yeshua. Shalom.